Listen up out there. I found the only picture of Spuds Buckley.
The Spuds Buckley diggy.
Linger longer, yes.
Spuds Buckley, a picture.
When I was doing overnights in Buffalo, I helped the morning show out, and I developed a character called Spuds Buckley.
What are you dressed in?
And it's going to be kind of a letdown, but you know, you'll see. It's a black photo that I found at the bottom of this box last night.
Mm-hmm.
I meant to bring it in today. I forgot, so I'll bring it in Monday. I promise, and we'll put it up on the websites.
Mm-hmm. Your glasses on in it.
I got bad sunglasses, a bad bandana.
Okay, it's good enough. Right there is worth the price of admission.
Really tight sweats because I'm wearing like two or three layers of sweats because it's cold out, and then a winter coat. That was
the attire of famous.
You're gonna be very disappointed.
But Opie, what was Spud's like personality?
I don't know. I forgot. I don't really remember.
If you had to guess.
Yeah, I can't even guess.
Well, was he silly?
I'll tell you this much, Jimmy. I just might find a audio tape of Spuds Buckley. Well, there's things we did in our past that we're kind of embarrassed about now.
Yeah.
Like, I brought in my Spuds Buckley picture today.
That was adorable. Huh? Yeah, the little black and white pictures of Opie dressed like Spuds Buckley. Which, it's not so much the dress that's disturbing as the little hat you're wearing is disturbing.
Hat? It's just a do-rag.
Yeah, whatever it was. It was a little disturbing. Your youth is very disturbing because you look like you shouldn't be with these men that are. It looks like a NAMBLA meeting. It's like men that are jocks at the station.
I always
and looked, then a little Opie.
I always looked way too young for my age. Always.
Is that also a white jacket?
Yeah.
Wow, dude.
What I feel like I look exactly the same, Jimmy.
That's what I that was. Yeah. Oh, wait, is that Spuds Buckley? That's actually not that bad.
No, I'm telling you, I told you ahead of time it's going to be a letdown. It was no big deal. It was more of a...
The voice would be the biggie.
Yeah, which I'll eventually find.
That's what you want to hear.
Huh?
You want to hear the voice.
Yeah, well...
How old were you, one?
One. I was probably just out of college. I looked like I was 15, I know.
Mm.
I'm always amazed, too. Like, you see a picture of yourself, and you're like, I really thought I did look like that. And then there's a mirror, and you're like, oh.
Oh, I know. That time is a bitch.
I know. It stinks.
No one gets past that one, unfortunately.
How old are you here?
Like I said, like 22, 23, somewhere around there.
God damn.
Yeah. We'll put the pictures up on onaradio.com later today. It's really, it's no big deal. Somebody from the station, you know, shot some black and whites as I'm out there, like, just messing around and In Buffalo morning traffic.
Oh, he's standing in the middle of the road for some reason.
Helping out, giving out free newspapers for the day.
All right.
Yes.
And then I like the news clipping about how you guys are hosting a listener appreciation party.
Oh, the press clipping?
Listener appreciation parties stink.
Well, no, it was just some artist that was performing at a local club. Let me see.
Yeah, but it said listener appreciation.
Are they all nice to you, these DJs?
Yeah, most of them I still like, actually, yeah. Iron Mike Benson is still cool doing radio up in the Buffalo area. Dwayne Daugherty's is like the king of Dallas radio. Bob Richards just got a job. Oh, God, he was just in the news. I know this is very inside, but he was a great PD. And Tony Magoo had his health issues, but I think he's doing better now.
It's funny because the guy's name is Iron Mike something, but I love how they always do it to you, too. They put quotes around the iron part.
Yeah, yeah.
Like you wouldn't be sure if that was his
name. That's not on my birth certificate. Oh. Please put a quote around it.
This is how sad this is. This is when we were doing a listener party for an artist called Chrissy Steele. I think she was from Canada.
Chrissy Steele.
Look up Chrissy Steele. She's
what the hell is she?
She's probably dead, but that's who we're in the picture with. We'll put these up on onaradio.com later today. Bill Kay saying, we demand Spuds Buckley. I can't find that fucking cassette. There is one, and I will find it. I'm not trying to make excuses, but that'll be the day that I call in sick. I will throw the cassette at Anthony, and I will run away.
Got to hear the voice.
Just think Jerry Lewis on Healy.
That's what I mean.
Can you do Spuds real quick?
No.
What you can remember.
No, I really can't.
He does these impressions. It sounds just like Spuds.
He does
Buckley.
These impersonations. You wish you'd never heard it.
I got a polyp. I got a polyp. I can't do it anymore. I got
so
a little
what?
Polyp on my vocal cord.
Oh, come on.
I could barely say Shirehorst.
Shirehorst.
Hey, why don't you put these Spud... Did you put these pictures up?
No, yeah, we're waiting for
you.
Okay.
I don't give a shit. I told you you could put these up.
Yeah, stop jerking off to me, Rook.
I was a handsome devil.
I'll say you were.
Ooh. Wow.
Spud's puzzly.
Sweatpants with really white sneakers with socks pulled up almost to the fucking knees. Nice look.
Yeah.
How do you check where your fucking things come in?
What you fucking right away you're getting fresh.
Wait, I'm breaking your balls right away. You fucking Spuds is getting fresh.
Let me tell you this. See this picture that's going up on the websites today?
Hey, yeah, yeah.
Oh, the Buffalo Bettys were enjoying this look.
Oh, yeah. Were they?
Yeah. Grow the hair long, man, and then wear a bandana.
Looks like you should be saying, pray for me.
What are you trying to say?
I'm saying that you were a douche in that time of your life, Jimmy.
I was scared, Anthony.
You see this fat bra in the background?
I understand.
She really, really wanted me to.
Yeah.
I was scared, guys.
I didn't want her. All right, I will do baby shit mustache today. One day only, though, man. I don't offer my...
Baby shit mustache.
I don't offer my services up often, but back in the day, Spuds Buckley would have done this. Stupid Spuds Buckley. God, I wish I could go back in time and punch Spuds Buckley right in his fucking
face. I'd love to
face.
Hear him talk just once.
And just kick him
I
in
want
his
to hear the voice.
Fucking still growing balls.
What did he sound like?
Oh, I don't know, Jimmy. He was a disaster.
Come on. Was he kind of like crazy? Like,
I fucking hate Spuds Buckley.
Why? How'd he talk? Was he like that or over the top? Or?
Oh, I would have just pushed him into traffic.
Yeah, what was it? Hey, I'm Spuds Buckley.
You got to do a little more la la la.
What's la la la?
That's Spuds Buckley.
He might have had a bit of a catchphrasey thing.
Oh. What might it have been?
Hey, brother man.
La la la?
Yeah, la 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 la.
Oh no, he didn't go la 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 la.
Bill K from Philly. Hey, my wife is doing 2 weeks. Do you want me to FedEx some shit up to you? No, today only.
La 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 la.
Not was like it, that.
How was it?
I don't know, from what you might remember.
I don't know.
Were there different words? Were you putting the la's, or did you actually say la?
I don't really remember, but I'll tell you this: if I could go back in time, I'd kick Spuds Buckley in his man cunt.
Why doesn't just take a guess at what he sounded like?
I don't remember, Jimmy.
But a guess.
I'm not going to step in.
La 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 la.
You do baby diaper mustache now. See, we negotiate. Who you think you're talking to?
No,
here?
No baby.
Give
diaper
and take.
Mustache.
With signatures on a paper proving that you'll do it.
Couldn't matter. You can't sign.
What would that? What would that
no
do?
No court would ever make me put baby shit on my face.
Like I could see Jimmy going no after he signs it, and then Ope going, "Well, I'll just take this contract."
Did the plaintiff do the Spuds Buckley voice? Yes, Your Honor, he did. Then you are required by law to rub the feces of an infant on your
That's
face.
That's right. Yes.
La 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 la
la la. What is it?
La la.
What would you say?
Maybe start slow and then get really fast and high pitched. Maybe.
Oh. Oh no. Ah, very close.
Oh. Would that maybe possibly happen during a phone call? At the end of it, was it the sign off?
Well, what I would do to Spuds Buckley if I could time travel.
But Spuds was a douche.
That cunt.
But was it at the end?
Oh, you look cool with your bandana on. Ooh, wow. That'll get the chicks.
What a douche.
Oh, I think I'll tuck my sweatpants into my socks. That's a good look.
Duh, oh, is that what you did?
Because that's what a douche like Spuds Buckley would look like.
Oh, I would fucking kick his ass.
Teach Opie a lesson.
You know,
bring your child's shitty diaper.
Yeah, somebody's got to straighten Opie out with a fucking little baby shit.
Yeah, you know
who
bluff.
You know who would extend this thing for a few days? Spuds fucking Buckley would have.
Really? What do you say?
Oh, he would have just like, you know, I don't know. I can't do his voice. Who would want to do that dumb voice?
What do you say? You don't do it.
I would cut out his vocal cords if I could jump in a time machine. That's what I would do to this Spuds Buckley.
But would he talk normal in the beginning?
I don't know.
But
Jimmy,
just guess. You might have remembered.
Know. If I could find the tape, you will get to hear
la,
this
la,
fucking
la,
prick.
La 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 But Spuds was crazy. Sounds crazy.
Oh, but Spuds would be like, well, today, tomorrow, oh, fuck, went Friday, whatever. Whatever it takes to get attention from me.
Ugh. Spuds liked a little attention, that's all. What
a fucking douche he was.
You think Spuds was a little over the top, maybe?
Ooh, you think?
I don't know.
Spuds Buckley, fucking $14,000 a year, asked for a raise. Oh, can I have a raise? No, you can't have a raise. Okay, boss, I'm sorry that I asked.
All right, Spuds.
All right, I'll continue collecting cans and stuff to try to eat. No problem. I won't cause any problems here at your radio station. Spuds Buckley was a douche. Fucking doing his own shift and then another 4 hours in the morning for no extra pay. Oh, that's Spuds Buckley. What a loser.
Wait, Spuds did his own shift?
Yeah, he was part of that fucking Young Opie show on... that was doing overnights, and then he went into Spuds Buckley character for the morning guy who was making fucking 100 to 200 G's. While Spuds Buckley made his 12,000, barely paying his rent, barely eating. Oh, that's okay, everybody, though. I understand.
How'd the name come about?
Use me.
That's a good question.
It's probably given to me, because why would he come up with something on his own? That little douche. Fucking hated Spuds Buckley. Hated everything about him.
I don't like the way Spuds represents the things in yourself that you don't like. Mm-hmm. You're talking right now to Young
Opie. Okay, Young Opie's done with his show. Now it's time to go in the bathroom with his Spuds Buckley costume. Ooh, where are they going to send him today? Oh, I don't know, but this is exciting. This is how you break into morning radio.
Yeah.
Oh, I'd fucking kick him in his man cunt. That's what I would do.
Spuds Buckley
Bash
is gone.
One.
Spuds Buckley stinks.
I love Spuds.
Oh, God, he stinks.
He's all I want to think about now is Spuds.
Hey,
fucking rules.
What do you think of the Spuds Buckley Super Bowl song, Iron Mike Benson? Come in here and listen to this. What do you think? It only took me 500 takes, but I'll make believe it was 2 takes.
Oh, it's great.
Oh, he stunk. God,
Spuds Buckley
did he suck.
Wait, he did a Super Bowl song?
Yes, it's Super Bowl Sunday.
Okay.
Oh, I would love to have heard that.
Might have sang a Grateful Dead tune, too, because, you know.
Oh, no.
Because that's wonderful.
Like, which one?
In the Spuds voice?
Yeah, in the Spuds voice, yeah.
Just being crazy and wacky?
Mm-hmm.
Looking for some attention?
Mm-hmm. No wonder Young Opie's girlfriend at the time was cheating on him with her old boyfriend the entire time. Oh, the signs were all there, but did Young Opie pick up on any of them? Of course
Spuds
not.
Spuds couldn't see it.
Of
I never heard of Spuds
not.
Buckley, but I hope he comes in with his baby.
Just fucking shit all over Spuds Buckley, Young Opie. Work for $12,000 a year. Go out with a chick that was fucking cheating on you. With a loser boyfriend that ends up dying of fucking of a drug overdose years later.
Mm.
Yeah, that's what she wanted instead of you. Oh, Spuds Buckley could suck out a big black cock. That's all I care about now. Time machine, head in the vice. That's what I would do to him.
How many people would use the time machine to just beat themselves up when they were younger?
See, but with our jobs, we got fucking proof that we actually lived as wimps. We lived as wimps. As wimps.
Yeah, I'll buy that. Yep.
Oh, please don't fire me. I just didn't want to do that promotion. I'm sorry. I was embarrassed.
We'll do it.
No, I actually...
Coffin's
well, here. I mean, Spuds Buckley might have had to do a sales gig. Where they might have wanted...
Oh, no.
They wanted Spuds Buckley and not Young Opie. How pathetic is that?
Did they know it was
and
the
same
guy?
And they might have wanted Spuds Buckley to dress up in his Spuds Buckley costume.
Who doesn't want that?
Hope they were selling douchebags.
And Spuds Buckley said yes because he was desperate and he really was collecting cans to get some change to get a can of that fucking Chef Boyardee so he wouldn't starve. So Spuds Buckley agreed and then he shows up and sees like really hot chicks going into the fucking bar and like... real men walking into the bar and now you're sitting in your car that's beat up and has close to 200,000 miles on it and you might have a bag next to you that has your Spuds Buckley
oh my God.
Costume.
Oh no.
And then you sit there in your car and after you start crying at how pathetic your fucking life is, you finally step up and decide you're not going to put the Spuds Buckley costume in and make a complete ass of yourself. But that doesn't make the general manager of the radio station happy, and he pretty much wants to fire your ass. So now you're in his office begging, and there might have been a few tears begging that you really needed this gig. Please don't fire me.
Crying Spuds Buckley?
Please don't fire me, boss. I just couldn't go through it. and I just really couldn't do this Spuds Buckley character at a bar.
All right.
Oh, what I would
I'm
do
getting
to this.
Deuce chills.
Get me a time
so bad.
Machine. Get me a time machine.
Just use it for that.
I would choke Spuds Buckley with his Spuds Buckley costume. That's what I would do.
Young Spuds got emotional. That happens.
Oh, that's what I would do.
Young Spuds wanted that job.
Why don't you give that up and just invest in, like, Apple?
What do you mean?
Well, if you could go back in time.
Oh,
you
yeah.
Know.
I would.
Microsoft or...
I would point
invent
at...
Invent Google.
I would go in a time machine. That's what I would do. I'd go in a time machine. I would... find Spuds Buckley. I'm sure he's still hoping that the Spuds Buckley character is going to take off. Probably been doing it for 10, 15 years at this point. Probably has a little paunch belly and squeezing into that old Spuds Buckley costume, are you? Because you're a one-trick fucking pony. And I would just mock him. I would point in his face and openly laugh at him. Yeah. Make him feel like very, very small and little. And then I would look for that Apple stock and get in early. That's what I would do with my time machine. What would you do with your time machine, Anthony?
Oh, wow.
What would you do to young Anthony?
I would have to set mine for probably 1937, around there. Give a little insight to a certain gentleman. Perhaps.
Where he might have went wrong.
Yeah, where he might have went. Tell him lay off Russia for a while.
I got some advice for you. You're really going to want to listen to me.
Yeah, you're really going to want to.
You're doing things a little bit wrong here.
Got some good machinery here. Don't waste it.
Right.
Yeah.
Anyway. Bang Vivian Lee in the ass.
Nice.
Hey.
Bend her over.
And there is a DJ out there that does have Spuds Buckley audio.
Oh.
And he's willing to release it if I just give the word, I guess. What? Yeah, I believe so. I got to give him a call. I don't believe he really has it, but he says he does. Spuds Buckley sounds like E-Rock. Yeah, that's why I beat up E-Rock. So he could wake the fuck up, and someday he'll be able to beat up young E-Rock.
Does he sounds like E-Rock?
Yeah, just eager and wanting to help and just...
Nothing worse than that. God, I hate that over-eager shit.
Just kissing everyone's ass.
I did that too much.
Did Spuds laugh at, like, the other DJ's jokes? If the other DJ's jokes weren't funny, would Spuds laugh just to be, like, one of the guys?
Oh, yeah, of course he would. Of course he would. He is the polar opposite of the voice you're listening to right the fuck now.
Spuds Buckley. Ugh.
Yeah. Oh, what I would do to him. Oh, I would just make his life a living hell.
I'd hang out with him.
Would you?
Yeah. Fucking have a few laughs. Toss a few back.
Leave him alone.
I might have talked to, like, toll booth collectors as I was going into Canada to do, a Spuds Buckley bit at a fucking Canadian strip club.
Whoa.
And then...
And were they all like, Spuds,
wow,
Spuds.
Wow, Spuds Buckley at my toll booth. Wow. What are you doing, Spuds? Well, sir. Almost went to the...
Character. Wow.
Well, sir.
Well, sir.
I'm off to the Canadian Ballet, see, because that's what people in Buffalo call the strip clubs
strip
in Canada,
because
they want to keep it from their wives and girlfriends, so they would say they were going to the Canadian Ballet. So I made a million jokes about going to the Canadian Ballet as Spuds Buckley.
I bet he had a high voice.
Oh, I would just feed Spuds Buckley alcohol and hope that he died in a drunk driving accident. On the way to his...
Was he allowed to drive, or was he too young?
On the way to his cheating girlfriend's house. That cunt!
She didn't want to be with Spuds?
I guess not. Because,
shame.
Yeah, she was with the coke dude. You know. And then...
Gotta go where the coke is. It was in the 80s, right?
And then the famous, where she left 15 messages on my machine having sex with with her old boyfriend.
Why?
When I thought I was going out with her.
Moaning and groaning into the phone.
Because she was a sadistic fuck. And that's the only type of woman that a Spuds Buckley was able to get back then.
That is a fantastic little vengeance tool there.
What?
Having sex on your answering machine.
That might have been the starting point of the change, though, because then a lot of the people that linger longer understand that I did take these phone messages and I did play them for her mom. Well, I played it for her mom's machine, because I knew her mom was at work. So she would come home to that. I just said, I just want to let you know what your daughter's up to. You know, she's still with the guy that you were praying she wasn't with. And I also might have did it to the father figure in her life, which would be her grandfather, who was 80 at the time.
Nice.
Oh, yeah.
He was on the tape with her.
Huh?
That's some good revenge, man. Good.
Yeah.
But you were also Spuds Buckley, so it didn't really matter. Negates anything you could have done that would have been cool.
No, it's funny. People bring up when Anthony, started, coming on my show and how eager you were.
Oh.
Dude, that...
So bad.
Spuds Buckley would have beat you in the eager department. Oh, my God. Just tell
really?
Me... Really? Tell me what I have to do. Tell me what humiliating thing you want me to do today, so hopefully I can make it in this business.
I just figured out you're Spuds Buckley.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I just figured that.
Yeah, that's the beauty of this, Dan.
Look at that.
It just shows the insanity that I want to actually go.
Do you think this is Fight Club? I just realized that's Tyler Durden. Holy shit. Wait a minute. You're Spuds Buckley? What?
I was like, why all this can tell? You feel bad for the guy.
No, he's a dick.
Here, why would you be, so mad at the guy? It's a poor thing.
Because that person is me.
Oh, now I get it. All right.
I love talking about,
it took me a while.
The old... It's a new bit that's sort of developing, Dan, just to let you in on it. Maybe we should have let you in on this before you came in today. Yeah. But I like to... talk to the old version of me.
Yeah, no, that's a good bit.
It would be nice.
I like the concept. Nice. I probably should have figured it out earlier.
No, I think it's funny that just Dan was like, wait a minute. So you're Spuds Buckley? What tipped you off finally?
Well, he's talking about the time machine. I don't know. I think a time machine, you want to go back to...
Dan, we played a tape of Ant and I from 12 years ago.
Horrible.
Oh, boy, what I want to do to that version of Opie, because this fucking guy had no clue what sarcasm was.
Just wanted to fucking
not
hit
even
both
a clue what sarcasm was, which is one of our greatest tools now. But back then we...
Is it?
But back then, not even a hint of what that could possibly mean, what it could do for a radio show, nothing.
I liked you guys back then. I thought you had a nice sense of humor.
Shut up! I love when Jimmy talks
about
that.
I did like you guys.
Because he sounds sincere almost.
You were fun. You were having a good time.
Yeah, I know, Jim. Thank you.
You guys were eager. I like that. Ready to please that audience.
Yeah.
Ready to please that audience.
And
yeah.
I bring this up, Dan, because people are thinking I'm insane. But let me tell you why I'm bringing this up. Rum Runner, she writes, right? Chick from Whack Bag, yes. From Springfield. She writes, I always thought when you got older, you matured. I'm 33 and I still feel insecure sometimes. Is this what the past does to us? Doesn't everyone have a Spuds Buckley to bring them down?
Ugh, no.
But you don't have, audio of it. Like, you have these distant memories of what you thought you were.
Mm.
Let's get serious for a minute. We all have distant memories of what we thought we were. You see an old picture and you're dressed like a douche and you just tell people, oh, that was the style back then.
Yeah.
And you can kind of brush it off and stuff. But in our business, we have actual Jimmy as well. Dan, I'm sure you have it too. We got old audio of us. No one saved their old audio.
Or video, yeah.
Or video, because we did a lot of, TV projects and stuff over the years. And it's
horrible.
It's really awkward to look back and you really realize that you were just a douche.
F U A B U! We ain't to take that to motherfucker!
Someone. Just signed their pink slip. They have no fucking idea what they just did. You have no idea. Bravo for taking a chance, but you have no idea what you just did to your career. You have no idea. Yes, Dan, that would be us.
Us? No, that was him.
Oh, like you weren't in camel right next to me?
Oh, fake camel. Right. I said plenty of dumb things that sounded really silly, but that wasn't it.
I was a catchphrasing asshole.
Mother hucker.
Mother hucker. Were just yelling, we hate you. You wanted them to know you hated them.
By the way, a little more to the puzzle. You know mother hucker? It's not even my thing.
Yeah, you said it was Weeze's, right?
I stole that from Weeze and made it sound like the faggiest thing that a human being could say. But when he said it, he was like street cool.
I imagine his delivery was
Vietnam
a little different.
Cool.
Yeah, yeah.
Absolutely.
I'm sure it wasn't.
Hey, ABU!
You want to know what we were doing there, Dan?
Yeah, what's that?
We might have been in a air balloon type of device.
Like a little hot air balloon.
Dirigible?
A dirigible.
A dirigible?
A zeppelin.
So it's kind of like a hot air balloon, but we could like motor around a little bit. And we might have been floating over a TV station that did us bad. And I can't even see this.
And drop bra bombs on them. It was bras with like water balloons full of paint in them.
But we call them bra bombs
and,
too.
And you know, we'd start out with the A cups, but then we'd hit them hard with the double Ds.
I went on YouTube.
And of course, there was no balloon, no airship, no nothing. We just did it like like we were fucking
doing it.
Yeah.
In a studio.
We wanted them to believe we were actually doing this, Dan. We weren't even mocking. Maybe
we thought we were
a bad radio
Orson
show.
Fucking Welles.
We
World
were the
Worlds.
Bad radio show.
Right? Dude, you hear that fucking audio, though. You think that they're outside. It's amazing. You get the propeller sounds. I'm like,
shut up, Jimmy.
I'm like,
the helicopter is coming strafe us, and it's pretty much...
Dude, go around them. I'm trying, man. I'm trying.
Oh. And it just sounds like... The helicopter sound, it sounds like the Red Baron.
Are you really trying? What about me? Hey, back off!
Back off, buddy!
Hey, that was a close one!
I know. Fucking two guys that have never done an illegal thing in their life are telling state trooper helicopters to go fuck themselves. Can he at least hear a second of that? Because Dan doesn't know what we're talking about.
I don't know if we even... I think we burned those tapes, right?
Yes, oh, they are gone. They are gone.
Yeah. Are they? They're looking for it. Maybe we should take a break. yeah.
How are we doing on that baby? Anybody?
Oh, we got, we got an hour
shitty
and 15
baby
minutes
face
left
thing.
In the baby diaper.
There's
got to
be somebody. There's always...
What?
The problem is that usually mommies are home with the babies.
Yeah.
And I don't know if a mommy would be as into this.
No.
Kind of
no,
thing as,
no,
a,
no.
as a daddy would be, you know?
No.
No.
What was the turning point? Let's say hi to Rich. Rich.
Hey.
Hey.
What's going on? I was just wondering, like, every superhero kind of has an awakening. I was wondering what was your, like, awakening moment when you decided to completely drop the Spuds thing and become Opie.
All right. Wow. Now you're going to make me really sad. The bear man who I love dearly, was the morning guy in Buffalo. And he did a different type of radio. More zooey, more fun.
Wacky.
And he enjoyed the services of Spuds Buckley.
Of course he did.
services?
Yes. The off-air services.
Did he get fired? I think he got fired because I think the station changed formats. We're going way back now. I don't remember exactly, but I think... Or he went back to Allentown where he was a big radio guy, and I think he's still there, actually. Haven't talked to him in years. He's a great guy. That's the truth.
Oh, okay,
and
cool.
The new guy came in from L.A., and he was a bit hipper, a bit cooler. His delivery was very, like, you know... He was just like almost, he almost started the whole, I don't give a shit about doing this, I'm just doing it, in between fucking, you know, acting roles in L.A. You know, he had that attitude, right? And I might have offered up my Spuds Buckley services. And he might have told me that he didn't need Spuds Buckley on his morning show.
Oh,
so
Spuds got the boot.
So I was forced. I wish I could even tell people... That I finally realized what a douche and just blow this fucking gimmick off. But no, I was told that he basically told me how stupid it was. And I was forced into early retirement.
How'd you offer
him, Buckley?
How'd you offer him the thing? Did you call him or did you go, hey, dude, I do this thing?
I might have auditioned for him. I might have sat down awkwardly. And
in studio on the air or off the air?
I don't remember, Jimmy, to be honest with you. I don't think it would have been, I don't think it would have been on the air. Almost definitely. But I might have, I definitely, you know, got a hold of him. Like, well, I was kind of successful with the Spuds Buckley with the Bearman show.
Yeah, rolled.
Give me a little taste. Let me have a little taste. And it opens on the phone.
No, I was face to face.
Oh, give me a little taste.
And I might have put myself out there, and he might have.
Wow, wow, wow.
And his facial expression and maybe the laughter pretty much made it evident that I would not be doing Spuds Buckley anymore.
But no, I call in. I'll say crazy stuff. And I'll go, la, 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 la.
I might have also as Spuds Buckley.
Yeah.
This one's...
Oh, my God.
This is really tough to acknowledge. There's actually a radio guy. You don't have a Spuds Buckley tape, do you?
No.
Oh, fuck.
Oh.
My heart just stopped.
We had something.
A radio guy, one of the only ones ever, by the way, got the best of me when I was doing Spuds Buckley. Because I thought it was a good idea, and it pains me to say this. I've got him back many times since then, by the way. It pains me to say that Larry Snorton Norton in Buffalo made me look like a complete and utter fool while I was dressed up as Spuds Buckley.
Why, did he hold up a mirror?
I got him back. Trust me, I got him back, and he paid. But at the time, I'd never felt lower. They thought it'd be a good idea, the Bear Man show, to have Spuds Buckley go to Larry's morning show, and he still does mornings in Buffalo, and knock on the window that was open to the streets and get his attention as Spuds Buckley as we're live on Bear Man show.
Yeah.
I'm like, and just like banging on the window and
that voice.
And kind of making fun of him and stuff and making fun of his bits and stuff. Now, a little known fact, I used to work with Larry at CMF where Weeze, you know, was king. So me and Larry had like a history back in the day. He comes walking out and I'm just beating him up in this Spuds Buckley voice, dressed as Spuds Buckley. And he goes, live on his show, he looks at me and goes, Greg, what are you doing? I'm like, I'm not Greg. Whoops. I'm Spuds Buckley, and I try to keep the character going, and he's like, what are you doing? You don't need to do this. You're a talented kid. Why are you doing this? This is all live on the radio, and I'm trying not to stay in character, and all of a sudden they just like kind of like turn around and ran away.
Kill
like,
him off.
Doing my la-la-las. Like, just going, he's right.
Is that the day
he's
you right. killed off Spuds?
He's right. He's so right.
Wait, you la-la-la'd away?
Yeah, I had to get out of this situation.
La, 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 la.
I couldn't say he was right, even though I knew he was right. And I turned and ran, doing my catch thing, and feeling like a big effing zero.
What did the Bear Man think of that encounter?
He thought it was great. But he was lying.
Did you come up with the name Spuds Buffalo yourself, or did somebody come up with it for you?
You think young Opie would come up with something as dumb as that? I don't think I did.
Wait a minute, were you Spuds Buckley?
How did
that
work?
I want to hear just the la la la.
Huh?
La la la.
That's all I want to hear.
Yeah, some people are saying this is boring. Well, you know, it's a look inside the brain.
Sorry, folks.
What can I tell you? All right. Behrman's still in Allentown? I think so. All right, we're going to take a break. And actually, we're going to change gears because how often did Opie cry himself to sleep? Well, 400 miles from home where my family and friends were doing radio for 3 years and overnights. Spuds Buckley for the morning show. Chick that was cheating on me with her old cokehead boyfriend. What do you think? Think I might have cried to sleep a few nights? Black guy thinking I'm a woman and attempting to rape me.
All right.
There's a lot of bad stuff that was happening in Buffalo. You heard that story, Dan?
No. Black guy raped you?
Real quick, because
raped them real quick.
Well, no, I didn't get raped officially, but I used to, you know.
I didn't get raped officially.
I used to grow my hair long.
He said, this is off the record, bitch.
I grew my hair long because, you know, that's what Spuds Buckley did because he wanted to fit in the rock and roll scene, man. I'm going to look just like Kurt Cobain.
I hope after the shots.
Without the talent and the attitude. Great. So there was a rapist, and it was a big story in Buffalo. And some dude was moving out of my brownstone, and I went to bed in the middle of the afternoon. I was exhausted, and I was sleeping, and I didn't lock my door. And I woke up, black dude in a hoodie. This is a true story. I was laying, I didn't even have like a box spring, so my mattress was completely on the floor. And I look up because a black guy is literally less than 6 inches from my face. He's right, like where our nose are pretty much touching. And I open my eyes to see this with a hoodie pushed hard around his face. And he was looking, I'm convinced to this day, that he was looking to see if I was a chick. So he could rape me.
Did he go la la la?
I went
scared.
All
away.
I did, it was the scariest moment in my life. All I did was I opened my eyes, I looked at him. I'm like, oh my god, don't move. Don't move. I'm like, and I just said, what are you doing? And that was good enough.
I'm raping you, motherfucker.
And it was good enough that he realized, thank God, that I guess, you know, I wasn't a female. I think he was looking for a female to rape. Ran out of my place, didn't take a thing, and he could have just wandered around my apartment before he woke me up. He could have got whatever the fuck he wanted. He wasn't there for money and shit.
Yeah, whatever he wanted.
Yeah.
True. He was there for Spuds Mankind.
Little Spuds.
That happened in the Spuds Buckley days.
So. 1 minute you're a fucking clipped robot lady. Rah, rah, and the next minute you're a menopausal psycho crying. And in front of a black audience, you're like, yo, what's up, motherfucker? How about you just be yourself?
And she doesn't know what that is.
Stop trying to figure out what you want to be when you grow up. Fucking fraud.
I finally found my own voice.
That same advice could have been given to Spuds Buckley.
Fuck Spuds Buckley in his fuckhole.
Wow.
That's what I say. Enough with this Spuds Buckley. It says, yeah, with a week to go until the Texas and Ohio primaries, stressed Clinton staffers circulated a photo over the weekend of a dressed, in quotes, dressed, Barack Obama.
Yeah, I'm surprised she didn't plant another question in the audience, too. Fucking phony bitch.
Yeah.
She makes me sick. Everyone in the country is starting to hate her now. And I love it. And they're hating her dumb husband, too, because he can't stop yelling. What's the matter, you baby? You're so used to winning, you can't let somebody else fucking have a shot?
He's, like, yelling at everybody that criticizes her.
Yeah. Your wife's a fucking twat with 30 personalities. Enough. I'm sorry, Bill.
She's this close to pulling a a Michael Richards at the Laugh Factory.
Oh, that would be great.
Hey, that's very funny, Dan. Dan performs at the Stress
Comedy
Factory.
Cellar.
What the fuck is wrong with me? Comedy Cellar.
Well, I've been to the Stress Factory.
No, I'm sure you have. But you're always at the
Always at the Comedy Cellar.
Right. I want to make sure people go and see if they have
ComedyCellar.com.
You got any TV stuff coming up? I'm not sure yet.
Yeah, not really, no.
No?
Dan's no, I got a whole lot of nothing. Although I got a CD that's being edited
as
we speak. Which hopefully will be out in a month.
We have any Dan Natterman clips in the master system? Because we'll play one for you.
Yes, well,
he's fucking hilarious.
Yeah,
Dan is
Dan's
hilarious.
Really funny.
I love your delivery on stage.
What's the name of the CD?
Well, it's tentatively called "Get Off My Property."
Okay.
So
you're shaking your fist on the.
Well,
comment?
Yeah. I'm like me
kids.
With a rake and just on a front lawn. Yeah. Will hopefully be on the cover. I haven't taken that photo yet, but. That's tentatively what it's called.
Are
either that or Spuds Buckley Live.
Said enough about Spuds Buckley. Mm. Please, sir. Please.
I'm trying to make up for the... Okay.
I forgot all about this douche, and I've been reminded of this idiot. Yes, this idiot that used to be me. Yes, I understand.
It wasn't you. Spuds was different.
Yeah, thank you, Jimmy. Jimmy's obsessed with Spuds.
That's all I think about morning, noon, and night. Do you understand the first thing I think of in the morning? When my girlfriend's even laying there, I'll just lean over and go, Spuds? She'll go, what?
Look, I'm still going through boxes, and I swear to you, if I find a Spuds Buckley cassette, I certainly will bring it in. It'll be...
Oh, yeah.
That one will get me. You know how I uncomfortably laugh when we play our old audio? I secretly kind of like it. I'm just twisted in that way. I'm twisted in that way. Not like the audio. I just like the experience and the feelings it brings me.
Oh, it's so cringe-inducing.
Right. But I'll tell you right now, the Spuds Buckley audio, I know I have a cassette somewhere. The label might have fell off, so I'm going to have to really dig. But if I do find it, I will bring it in, but I will be mortified. I really will. I really, really will. All right, One Vision Live reads. Any one of these will work, you think?
The first one was the best.
Today?
Yeah. No, the other day.
The other day?
Well, I'm sure they're all okay, too.
You want to set this up, Jimmy? Because we really forgot that XM, you know, the faithful XMers, they don't hear this. It's a local spot we're doing in New York when we go to commercials.
I do live reads because One Vision did my eye surgery, and I'm very happy with the results. So we, you know... I was very happy to do live reads for those guys. They honestly did a professional job. I mean, they made me comfortable, and the surgery went off very well, and they did what they said they were going to do very well. So I'm happy to do reads for them, and now E-Rock got his surgery, and he's doing reads with me.
Right.
But his acting stinks.
I don't understand why they had to take it to the next level, because you were doing a great job, and then they're like, all right, well, I know what this needs. We need to get E-Rock involved. So Jimmy does a great job, and then E-Rock just...
20. He says 20. Where is E-Rock?
Hi, E.
Hi, E-Rock.
Hello.
No surprise. We're making fun of you again.
Yeah.
You remind me of Spuds Buckley. I bet you that's why I'm so mean to you. It's all coming together now. This is going to help me heal. That's why I fucking beat the shit out of you. Because you remind me of a young Opie, young Spuds Buckley.
I'm glad to help.
Can you put on the outfit?
Please, you look.
It'd be way better than going into a time machine, because I don't know what that's going to do to your system after you come back.
All right.
They don't have that figured out. They have the time travel thing figured out, but they don't know what happens to you down the road.
Mm-hmm.
So if you just dress up as Spuds Buckley and I could punch you in the face a few times, dude, that would make...
Punch you in the face.
That would make me so fucking happy. Would you do that for me?
I don't want to get punched in the face. I'll wear the outfit, but...
How about this, Pip? We get a boxer in here to dress like Spuds Buckley. We give you gloves, and he has the helmet and stuff, and we let you strike him.
No, it has to be E-Rock. It all came together. E-Rock, you let me beat the shit out of you as you're dressed as Spuds Buckley, and you got the black and white pictures.
Yeah.
Hence, a long time ago, by the way. But you got dressed exactly like him. The dopey bandana, the stupid risky business sunglasses, the sweatpants tucked into the socks, the awful white fucking basketball sneakers, and a big radio station jacket, which just messes the whole thing up. Now you're not even the character anymore, but it was cold. You dress like that and let me punch you in the face as hard as I can. I will never, ever bother you again.
No.
Because it'll finally come out of me.
No. I don't want to get punched in the face.
That's too bad. I would have done it for you.
Are you queer?
Yeah, what's wrong with you? Ugh, I hate you. What? What happened?
This is luck. Kind of looked at you a little.
Whatever. One Vision. So you got, someone just came into this. Yeah, and there goes the door slamming. Ooh. Go fuck yourself.
Ooh. Oh, he's holding up his hand saying, I didn't slam the door.
Fair enough. You didn't slam the door. All right, I'll give you that one. Fair enough. Still hate you. One Vision. So now E-Rock's doing the live reads with Jimmy. Why is this a soliloquy? Is anyone else gonna talk today?
Well, we're listening to you.
I'm starting to get very uncomfortable here. I know, but I want to.
Waiting
for
the E-Rock thing.
I'm admitting way too much shit.
I'm waiting to hear the audio and the E-Rock thing, so we can laugh at him some more.
Yeah. So this is, I swear there's probably a handful of people that have heard this. Everyone else has not. So Jimmy doing his fine One Vision read, and then all of a sudden E-Rock has to jump in.
This is what we do on the commercial breaks in New York at K-Rock.
Yeah.
Hey, this is Jim Norton from One Vision again. LASIK is all about the doctor and their technology. I'm so happy I had it done. Safety and experience were very important to me. I was afraid. Every patient, when you go to One Vision, is evaluated and consulted.
Sorry, but Damien from Akron, Ohio. He writes, is there a XXXL Spuds Buckley outfit?
Oh,
I get it.
See, we
poor E-Rock.
We would have to find an XXXL version of the Spuds Buckley costume for you to play. All right. Anyway, sorry.
Poor Eric.
I just love E-Rock fat jokes.
By a real doctor.
Who doesn't?
Not some idiotic trained salesperson. You talk to a real doctor. E-Rock?
He should walk me through the process, the procedure. Easy.
Oh, God. Oh.
Fucking mic was off.
Mic isn't even on. He's just babbling.
They paid for this.
He should walk me through the process, the procedure. Is easy.
Dummy.
Thank you. And 5 minutes after the procedure, I was seeing 2015. So
they're
best thing ever made.
For this, you dummy.
Well, what you missed E-Rock saying was really not much. He did the best he could. He said he could see again, and he now has a clearer vision into his fridge. My procedure took 10 minutes. Now you can get LASIK.
All right, so that was that one. Jimmy just so annoyed.
I like the first one.
Yeah. This was later.
Jim Norton for One Vision. You know, LASIK surgery, it's all about the doctor and the technology. Experience and safety, for me, were the most important things, and I felt that at One Vision. Every patient there is evaluated and consulted by a doctor, not some sales professional.
Hey, it's E-Rock. I was afraid to do LASIK, and Matt at One Vision made it so easy, explained the whole process. The procedure was really fast. I came out with almost perfect vision 5 minutes after the procedure. It's great, One Vision.
Yeah, good. I love the fact that I wake up and don't need my glasses or my contact lenses. You know you're sick and tired.
That's it for that? Probably. Yeah.
Oh, I love it. Yeah.
All right, that's, hold on. Got a couple more.
The first one is when he says 2015.
That's the one I'm trying to find.
2015.
20. Fucking Ernie enunciating. 2015.
You guys are like the worst pairing possible.
I know.
For anything.
Hey, this is Jim Norton for One Vision. LASIK is all about the doctor and the technology. Safety and experience, by far the most important things when you decide to have LASIK. Every patient is evaluated and consulted by a doctor, not some trained sales professional.
Hey, it's E-Rock. I wanted to do LASIK for years, and this Friday I finally had it done. Matt at One Vision walked me through the whole process. The procedure was fast and easy, and now I'm seeing 2015.
Okay, I didn't know you were seeing 2015. My procedure took 10 minutes. I am seeing, I think, 2020. Now you can get LASIK at One Vision for zero down, zero for 2 years.
This guy's got to be great because he didn't fall asleep during E-Rock's procedure.
Call today for a free consultation at 1-800-926-2015. That's 1-800-926-2015.
So, whatever.
Sorry, E-Rock. You're a better actor than I gave you credit for.
Oh, by the way, it is a monologue, not a soliloquy. Well, don't worry.
Hi, it's Eric. You didn't really sound thrilled about it, because then when you sounded thrilled, we made fun of you because it sounded fake.
Yeah. Yeah, so...
Because you put on the voice, your garlic butter shop voice. I was like, hey, yeah, I had the surgery done myself, and fast and simple, and...
Well, yeah. When we started these live reads, there was a camera right in my face, there's Than pointing and laughing, there's you throwing stuff at me.
Mm.
What was the excuse from today, then? None of that was happening.
No.
Who's chomping their teeth? Was it you?
No. That's
me.
E-Rock.
That's me now.
Who's chomping their teeth? Who's the cokehead?
E-Rock. He's just having an instinctual reaction to thinking about eating.
Poor E-Rock. He's not that fat.
No, he's a little chubby boy.
Slightly obese.
Just slightly. You're a little chubby boy. That's all.
No, but it's not ridiculous. I mean, like...
Right. Well, no. I mean...
No, there's several problem areas, but other than that...
You're unfuckable, but you're not too fat to be friends with.
He's not...
And what's good is he's young, and it only goes away when you get older.
Yeah.
You don't get fatter. Stuff, which is good, you know.
How do you feel, Rock?
How do I feel? I don't know. I feel okay. Not right this second, but in general, yes. And there's the camera.
Sam will come in with a camera anytime E-Rock's on the hot seat. He comes in with that camera just to nail him. My camera.
Let's say hi to Sean in Boston. Sean, what's up?
Hey, what's going on? Yeah, Jimmy's whole read is all about how he only talked to doctors and it was such a great procedure. Then E-Rock comes on, he's like, yeah, I talked to Matt. Matt said it's a good idea.
That is true. I say that you don't talk to him. He just threw the Matt thing in.
Right.
I was told. Okay, right, but it's not in the copy. So I'm saying that, you know what, it's only doctors, not salespeople. Then he jumps in and goes, yeah, you're right. Matt, the sales guy, walked me through all of it. Matt actually did my surgery in the elevator with a fucking penknife.
Bless you.
What is Matt, God?
Let's say hi to Lou in Sayreville. Lou, what's up?
Hey, what's up, guys?
Hey.
Hey, nobody loves bashing stupid E-Rock more than I do, but I gotta admit, Jimmy sounds like a cancer patient reading over his chemotherapy brochure and what the side effects are gonna be.
Well, that's very hurtful.
The two of them are like a disaster.
Well, sir, my acting is known to be very dicey at best. And on that one, I happen to be just, when they give me copy to read, I have to kind of read it. But I don't sound like a cancer patient, so I seem like a happy LASIK customer.
You guys are no Lennon and McCartney, though.
No, we're not.
Yeah. You're kind of...
We're fucking Yoko and Heather Mills.
All right, now what?
Bang,
ding, ding. Oh, sorry.
You rock anything?
Nope.
Okay.
How was your weekend?
Uneventful.
What did you do with your new sore eyes?
Not a whole lot. I had to go to an event for my chick's work, and that was it. It was a pain in the ass.
What was the event?
Some concert they were having.
What concert?
Tonic. A group called Tonic.
Tonic is still performing?
Tonic, that's, yeah. Back when we were at AAF.
Open your eyes, right? Or something like that? To open up your eyes.
Back when we were taking dirigibles and bombing TV stations.
They're still out there?
Yeah, the lead singer has a new album, so they were out there doing a performance for her station.
What station did she work for?
Fresh.
Fresh.
Fresh. Fresh.
Tonic used to be like a rock band.
Yep.
We used to play them on the rock station.
Not anymore.
And now they're playing for Fresh?
Mm-hmm.
Oof. That's a long fall.
Yeah.
Wow. He went from cool to Spuds Buckley.
Look at E-Rock. I'm taking my headphones off. I got things to do.
All right, E-Rock. You know you're bombing.
I got things to eat.
E-Rock.
He's not fat. He's not.
Oh, his theme music. Wow. That.
What?
It's been a while.
He doesn't seem that. He doesn't not really fat.
Oh,
you see his neck?
He's portly.
Dan.
He's not Ralphie May.
I love Dan's observation.
How many planets are?
You're right. If you were a listener to the show and one of probably 99.9% that will never see what we look like, right, you would assume that E-Rock is a very fat
just
dude.
A monstrous load.
He's like, but he's like skinny fat. And it's more about how he has no self-control.
Yeah.
So you want to hear the explosion?
Yeah.
Not the actual explosion, but how they're reporting it?
Yeah.
Okay. Here you go.
Oh, la 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 la.
Oh, no.
Good morning, Bearman.
Oh, wait a minute. That's something else.
Oh, my God.
That's something else.
Oh, my God.
Anyway, let's start.
That? No.
What? What are you talking about?
No, that wasn't what I thought it was.
All right. So
is that what I thought it was?
Oh, yeah, it was. Yeah,
what
it was.
What are you talking about?
Yeah, hold on.
What are you talking about? I got the news story of this.
No, I know what that was.
You used to do some news reports?
That was...
No, I got the, you know, there's an explosion in Times Square.
Let me hear that clip again.
What clip?
The clip you just played of the explosion.
No, what are you talking about?
The clip you just played.
Of the explosion?
You know, la, 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 la. Hello, Bear.
Yeah, I'll be very interested in hearing that as well.
So we got a Times Square explosion story here.
Uh-huh.
Well, let's just show you what we've got right here. We are at 41st Street and Broadway. And you can see right here to your left, we have police here at 41st. The whole Times Square area is frozen. It's shut down. They are turning people away. The reason for that is... that is the Armed Forces recruiting station. We talked with a number of eyewitnesses. They tell us that the front of that building is blown out. The glass that is on the front of that building blown out by an explosion.
The front of the building being blown out is different than the windows being broken.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. It just is.
Yeah. Yeah. That's all we got so far on that.
Yeah, that's it.
Well, yeah, that is it.
Where's the... Yeah.
No, that is it.
Is it?
Yeah, that's all you get.
I'd love to hear more. Believe me, I would love to hear more.
All right.
Let's take a look at some video we shot here in Times Square about an...
What?
Wrong clip. You put the wrong thing.
Yeah.
No, you guys said you wanted to hear more, so I'm playing more. It's the Times Square explosion story. This is a big, big story today in New York City.
I'd rather hear of an explosion or a career blowing up than a Times Square explosion.
Something about Bearman?
Yeah, I heard something.
What are you talking about? This is big. We got to get into this a little bit. Times Square explosion. My favorite clip, we got the report.
No, I'll tell you what my favorite clip is.
What?
The one I heard about 5 minutes ago.
Mine too.
What?
I want to hear more of that.
What are you talking about?
I don't know, to tell you the truth.
What are you talking about? The report talks about his own experience out there.
Oh, the reporter. Yes, of course.
Let me tear down a wall for everybody. You really think it's just going to be that easy?
Of course not.
You're going to have to invest some time in listening to this show today, tomorrow.
Oh, but I want to hear it.
Maybe as far as Monday or Tuesday. You don't think I just started doing this radio thing, do you? The chatter has begun. We got more audio after the break.
Yeah, I can't wait to hear this audio.
Oh, la 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 la.
Oh, no. Oh wait, that's not it. We got more audio after the break.
Oh.
We got.
I don't know if I can listen to that.
Listen to what?
What I just heard.
My jaw and stomach hurts.
I know. Yeah. It's physical pain to listen to that. But I'm so glad.
Why did I have to unpack boxes?
Well, reports are coming in. Yes.
So here's our moving tribute to Patrick.
Okay.
Swayze, as we go to break.
La 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 la.
No.
Good morning, Bearman.
Why does that keep popping up?
I don't know, but
what the?
Wow.
The disc is labeled "Retard Sing Time of Your Life." And
no. I kind of
Why is that popping up all over the place?
It obviously got mixed up in the retard file.
But look, it says it right on there. Time of my life. A little strange.
Time of Opie's life.
Something strange is going on today.
Back in his old radio career days.
Let's say hi to Brian on Long Island. Brian, what's up?
Yeah, I was going to ask you about that Boston party you're going to.
Well, the River Rave, which is huge, and they're bringing it back this year. Very excited. You got STP reuniting, and you got a Filter getting back together for it. Yes.
It's great.
I'm sure that's not going to be STP!
Beep, beep. That was such a hack.
Well, at least that was, you know, a little later in your career. It wasn't like, I don't know, some character you used to do.
La 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 la.
Good
morning, Bearman.
What the hell? That was supposed to be a commercial, E-Rock.
It was for suicide.
Everything is labeled wrong today.
Yeah, huh? Why, was that labeled good?
What is that?
That sounds... I don't know. I hear...
That sounds a little weird.
I hear tell, maybe in the early days of... Greg Opie Hughes' career. It may have been a character.
What? I was, by this point in my radio career, I was going by the name of Opie.
Oh, Opie.
It's a little known fact that, yeah, in my Rochester days, if you tuned in late night in the middle of the night and you heard this hacky DJ, he might have been going by the name of Greg Opie Hughes.
Right.
Wait a minute. One thing I noticed during that clip, too.
What clip, Jimmy?
Just whatever it was, like the accident I played.
Yeah.
Was that it sounds like the Bearman goes,
Yeah, not again. This guy.
Oh, no. This crazy caller that I went to knowing it was him.
This is going to get wild now, people. Strap in.
Well, I mean, let's be accurate. It wasn't a crazy caller. May have been, a real-life person stopping by to say hi.
Of course it was. Oh, that was in studio.
To discuss some shenanigans that were about to happen. Possibly. You know. But I wouldn't know because...
You wouldn't?
Just like you, I'm out in the dark with this one.
You are? Yeah. Because
yes,
I don't know. I've heard lots of stories about this certain character over the years. Years I've heard about this.
Yeah.
I even remember maybe you doing an impression of what this character may have sounded like. And it could never
Minute. Are you trying to say that Spuds Buckley...
I am indeed saying I believe that is Spuds Buckley, the character you used to do back on the Bearman's show.
On the Fox.
On the Fox many years ago.
In the city of Buffalo.
Hey, Bearman.
Which is now the Edge.
And
the home of Shredder Reagan. The great Shredder Reagan.
Why the la la la
why? Why not just hello, Bearman?
Yeah.
I've been doing radio.
Why did Spuds have to be such a douche?
I've been doing radio since I was 18 years old.
Mm-hmm.
You honestly think I'm going to give you that answer right now?
Is that a picture of Spuds Buckley?
Yeah, that's up on where?
Oh. The site we can't talk about.
We can't talk about that's named after our this fine radio show might have a picture of what Spuds Buckley looks like.
Spuds Buckley. Oh, God, is that horrible. Oh, God, no. Oh, my.
What, man? Do-rags were very in at the point at that time.
Cringing. That with the voice.
Got to have the same hair loss. All right, I'm holding on to it. That's good.
La, 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 la.
Lost a little in front, but it looked like I lost a little in front, what, 12, 15 years ago.
Is that on onaradio.com?
It was. Maybe Steve Ness from Bayshore could pop that back up today. I'm sure he will, knowing him.
Wow.
Hey, man.
Wow.
Yeah. You know,
all I can say.
A blank's got to eat. A blank's got to eat.
Yeah.
What's Spud's chewing on in there?
Just a stir for my coffee.
And where's the,
What?
Where's the,
What?
Where's the glasses? Weren't the glasses too?
Well, it was,
A break?
Sunglasses, because I was outside, and I had to be kind of cool, man.
Oh, no, you're in the middle of the road.
My character had to be
zoom in
cool.
On it, I'll smash your face.
Is this some kind of gasoline promotion?
Well, the pictures will be up later on radiostations.com. I don't know what I'm wearing there. Like, I know I'm wearing sweatpants with the bottom of the sweats tucked into white socks, and then I got, like, white basketball sneakers. And then I got really thick gloves because it is Buffalo and it is winter. And then I got a station jacket on, which the character needed for whatever reason. And then I got something on my head.
Yeah.
Should have been an anvil.
Is it a Santa Claus hat? What is on my head? What is on my head?
I don't know, but from the sound of that clip, there was nothing in it.
What clip?
La, la, oh. Hi, Bearman.
Oh, God.
La, 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 la.
No.
Good morning, Bearman.
Good morning,
Bearman. Good morning, Bearman. The Bearman's going, oh, no.
Oh, here he is.
Oh, boy.
Strap in, folks. Here it comes.
Wow.
That was his way of going, tune out, folks, and come back in 5 minutes.
I may have obtained four clips of this.
Four clips
of this character.
This is more valuable.
I may have.
This is more valuable than that stupid Helen Keller photo they found.
Yeah.
I may have in my possession, thanks to somebody that works in radio, four clips.
Wow.
This isn't even the cassette that I might have possession of that I haven't found yet in those boxes that I'm, unpacking.
Well, I'd love to hear some of it. Why no, that's it? Not going to happen.
Well,
not quickly enough for me, for my liking.
The faithful listeners will get to hear it eventually.
We've been talking about this since 2001.
Yeah, no.
That was the worst part about getting thrown off the air. I'm going to have to wait to hear Spud Buckley. Good morning, Bearman.
In time, my friends, in time. But right now.
All right. We started this yesterday. We should finish this today.
Spuds Buckley?
What? What are you talking about?
I thought that's what you were going to do. Oh, but we didn't start it yesterday.
Good morning, Bearman.
Yeah, that was it. Wait.
La, 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 la. Good morning, Bearman.
Good morning, Bearman.
La, 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 la.
No.
Good morning, Bearman.
Oh, I got goosebumps of douche chills. Holy fucking freezing.
Hey, man.
Oh, God.
Hey, man.
Hey, man.
Someone had to pave the way for this.
Wow.
This fucking dynasty.
Pave the fucking way. You were macheteing through jungle. That wasn't even paving yet. I don't know what the fuck that was.
La, 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 la.
Wow. You know something?
Yeah.
I got to give it to you, though. That's bravery. That's bravery. Because that tape would have fucking ended up in the fireplace, and I would have went, I couldn't find it, guys.
That's the beauty of our show. Actually, someone else found it, so I knew I had to, like...
Oh, you had to. They would have been like, hey, where's that Spuds Buckley tape I sent into Opie?
I got a cassette filled with my great Super Bowl song I sang for everybody.
As who?
As the Spuds Buckley
character. Oh, no.
Had in one line of it. Go, just one line.
Oh, no. Look how embarrassing.
It's Super Bowl Sunday, but I sung that.
But I sung that.
Wait. It's Super Bowl Sunday.
No.
And was Bearman just like, oh no. Oh gosh, he's in here again. Why? We can't keep him out.
Spuds Buckley, what do you need, Spuds?
I don't know why. He just runs in here and Security's never there to punch him in the face and throw him out on the street.
The award will be called the Spuds Buckley Award.
Oh, la 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 la.
The la 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 award for brand new animators as part of the Animation Festival.
Oh, here he comes again.
Oh, no.
Oh, look who it is, everybody.
Not this character. Oh, you're a character. No.
Do you think people at home are like, oh, Spuds Buckley's coming in?
This is my favorite part of the show.
Stop. Spuds Buckley's on.
No,
Spuds
I Buckley's don't.
No, you don't.
Douche. I don't think
what a douche he was.
I don't.
Oh, if you only had a fucking time machine.
Oh, man, I'd give him testicular cancer.
Would you?
No problem. No fucking problem. I would probably, if I could get into a time machine, I'd go back. I'd find Spuds Buckley, who is a young version of me, and I would fuck myself in the ass.
Wow. You would fuck yourself in the ass.
And it's not gay because you're fucking yourself
ass. It's yourself. It's your own ass. Jerking off.
Right.
But Spuds Buckley would be like, you would know because you went into the time machine.
Right.
But he wouldn't know.
No.
Because he hadn't gotten to that point yet. So he just thinks he's being ass raped.
Right.
And you're just having fun and it's a goof for you.
Yeah. Waking him up so maybe he could develop a little faster so he doesn't have to stay in these shithole markets year after fucking year.
Maybe that's what happened to him. That's why his voice was like that. Bear man. My hiney is sore. Good morning.
Good morning, Bear man.
Oh, I can't take it. It is like, how do you get so much from 4 seconds, you fuckers?
It's just so bad. That's how bad it is.
I thought that was an hour.
Dude, that's at least the beginning of 1 to 2 minutes of material. And that's all you get today. Because that's the brilliance of me.
La, 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 la. Oh, my goodness.
Good morning, Bearman.
Good morning, Bearman.
Oh no.
Here go the ratings.
Oh, hey. Spuds, you've done it again.
It's true.
Let it
done
be
one.
Sucked. Another piece tomorrow.
Opie. Oh, wow. Maybe the black. This is the guy that knows how to linger longer. Maybe the black guy. This is Matt Lamb from the city. Maybe the black guy in Buffalo was Ope in blackface going back in time to fuck himself in the ass.
Hey,
that's right.
Wow. That could have been you.
And then he gives me a linger boo boo boo.
He had to go through the chimney, that's why. Maybe he landed in the chimney.
Yeah,
and it was soot.
Sooty. Dude. You got a little sooty.
I should have known, man. That whole rape thing that almost happened to me. God damn it, that was me going back in a time machine.
That means at some point you are going to find a time machine.
Right.
But if you are going to, why don't you just...
Well, now I'm going
to
do it, right.
Come back now and say something to yourself.
Right.
Like what?
Just to prove that, you know.
Oh.
I don't know. Walk in.
Spuds.
Say la la la.
La-la-la! Good morning, Bear. Oh, no.
Good
gravy. Here
comes
some madcap fun.
Shut up.
Madcap.
Oh, boy, strap in, folks. Give me one of those days. He's here again. This crazy.
He's incorrigible.
Yeah. La, la, la.
And by incorrigible, I mean completely unfunny.
Hello, Bear Man. That should be followed by a gunshot. Do you have one in the replay?
I'm laughing because I don't want to cry. Laugh. Let me see something here. Really
right? Oh, yeah. I would love to hear that.
This is my impression of that day. La, 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 la. Good morning, Bear Man.
Hey, I'm getting props. Bobby D from Brockton writes, Opie needs to sue the creators of SpongeBob for stealing his Spuds Buckley voice.
Yeah.
See? I was an innovator.
You know who's giving you props? Time. Spuds B from Buffalo.
Stupid Spuds Buckley.
You know who should give you props? A Cessna 180.
Sorry, or Carrot Top here. Improve that bit.
You guys, you were telling about how you sat there listening, I think it's called Willie's Place now, but the Hank's Place channel?
Yeah.
Just sitting there listening to old, depressing country music.
Dude, because I was out of work for 2 years. I was just driving around. I had XM way, way before we ever got a gig, and I was lonely, man. Hank's Place got me through some tough times on the road. The truckers know what I'm talking about.
Just, the truckers know.
I didn't even know half the songs, but man, I was... That's me in my life.
Everything died in my life. Everything.
Jeez. Well, at least Spuds Buckley was one of those things.
Let's say hi to Doug in Philly. Doug, what's up?
I just wanted to say, good morning, Opie. All right.
Well, that sounded like Spuds. Sounded similar to Spuds Buckley.
Spuds Buckley would have had those pictures up immediately.
What do you...
I'd love to hear his... I missed Friday's installment, by the way. I did miss Friday's installment. I was really...
I didn't give anybody a taste of Spuds Buckley.
But
on
you
Friday.
Promised.
Well, I did, but
we got the old school Spuds Buckley, the one we heard a couple of times already.
Yeah, well...
You know.
All right, I'll...
La, 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 la.
I love Bear Man going, whoa, hey.
Hey, hey, oh boy, here it is.
La, 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 la.
Oh, no, no, no.
Good morning, Bear Man.
You want another taste today?
No.
I have to.
Fudgy, wudgy bars.
What?
Well, can we have one more time at that? I just didn't hear it because God intervened and shut my hearing down.
Mercifully.
Fudgy, wudgy bars.
Fudgy, wudgy was?
Fudgy, wudgy bars.
What's wrong with that?
Ladies and gentlemen, put them together for Spuds. Buckley.
Buckley.
Who said that?
Ladies and gentlemen, put them better for, together for a Spuds a Buckley. That's, my pal, Bear Man, who does mornings in Allentown.
Oh, boy,
that's all you get for now.
That, no.
For now.
No.
For now. For
no,
now.
No.
We're in the middle of baby diaper mustache.
No. I'll roll up a newspaper and hit your nose. No.
So,
oh, my God.
We got to finish the baby diaper mustache thing. I got one more clip to play.
You're only playing that Spuds right now, by the way. He's a very smart dude because he knows that this is going to overshadow it. So the audio was played.
Yeah.
But... The deliciousness under the nose will overshadow.
Look, if people remember, then we'll give them a little taste later on or tomorrow or something. But there you go. We got
line of the day.
Here comes la 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 la.
Line of the day.
Line of the day.
Line of the day.
You weren't snooping. You weren't here, and we had to, like, look for stuff, and that's what we found in your drawer.
Waste not, want not.
Fudgy, wudgy bars.
Oh, God.
What was that?
Hi, baby.
What? Get the fuck. Give me the only copy. Give it to me. I don't leave until I get it back.
All right.
I don't trust you fuckers anymore. Thank you.
Run off copies.
This is the only copy. It goes home
with
me.
If that's actually the only copy, our staff should be fucking shocked.
Oh, yeah. Well, something tells me it's not.
I don't think it is.
Shut up.
La, 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 la.
Oh, no, no.
Good morning, Bear Man.
Oh, no, 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 no.
Ladies and gentlemen, put them together for Spuds. No. Buckley.
Buckley. Spuds, Buckley. See, he was happy that I came by.
No,
well,
he wasn't.
We can't hear the...
Fudgy, wudgy bars.
It's too. It's honestly too short to understand what you say. Fudgy, wudgy bars?
Bars, yeah. He used to be a people on Jones Beach that would walk around with coolers. What? And they'd be like... Fudgy wudgy bars, fudgy wudgy bars, ice cream, and they like sell that's, shit.
So was Spuds selling fudgy wudgy bars?
Dude, yeah, what was Spuds doing with the fudgy wudgy bar?
Dude, E-Rock gave this to me today, and it says Spuds Buckley, 103.3 The Fox in Buffalo, New York. The tracks are labeled as follows: The Fox Fool Parade, Spuds the Vendor. I don't remember.
That's probably Fudgy Wudgy Bar.
Yeah, Spuds isn't selling much. Then number three is Mert Snort. Spud's still selling. And then float commentary, more Spud's wackiness.
Wackiness.
Where's E-Rock? Does he know? Could he explain this?
Oh, no.
We can't start this now.
That's we can see. This is a couple seconds.
The Fox Buffalo's home of quality. Rock and roll. Hey, 636. Gracious, good morning. You're on your way with the Bear Man. We got the whole Fox crew. We're here at the... excuse me, at the reviewing stand on the for the first annual Fox Fools Parade. We're located just 1/2 mile west of Furman Boulevard near Shooters. And they're still working on getting some of the barriers.
Some of these vendors we got over here, they want to know where the hell they're supposed to be.
Vendors. Where's oh, let's look at the paper. Well,
la 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 la.
No.
Good morning, Bear Man.
What?
Holy
the hell is that?
Holy Jesus, Mother of God!
What selling the wasn't hell is that? E-Rock?
Crap.
That's Spuds going around selling stuff at the Fox Fools Parade, watching the floats go by. People setting up displays and stands and various products for the people of Buffalo to come and buy.
Well, like what? There's no. We don't.
Yeah. I need to hear more.
Like what? Well, I don't remember this.
Ladies and gentlemen, put them together for Spuds. Oh, no. Buckley.
I'm here to make a buck this...
All right, I can't listen.
Oh, no. Come on. You're here to make a buck.
Oh, at least get to the catchy slogan.
I'm here to make a buck. Yeah.
Come on. Let it rip, man. Let it roll. Oh, God. No.
I'm here to make a buck.
Sup, Buckley.
I'm here to make a buck this morning.
Spuds, when aren't you here to make a buck, huh?
Hey.
So do you have your vendor permit?
Yeah.
Well, I'll trust you, okay?
Okay.
Now, you're gonna be vending up and down the parade route today?
I'm going to be selling fudgy wudgy bars this morning. And I got a slogan.
Yeah?
A buck...
All right. Come on. Why'd you shut it off?
Well, we got to hear the slogan at least.
A buck for a... Let me see. What could it be?
Why are you selling fudgy wudgy bars? That was cute.
Why are you putting it away? Why? It was a buck for something. A buck to punch Spuds in the face.
How about you rub a fudgy wudgy bar, make a mustache out of it?
He's just leaving. He's just leaving.
I'm going to make a buck. Fudgy wudgy bars.
Oh, he left. He walked out. Oh, he just walked out of the studio.
I think it's cute.
Holy shit.
Spuds is cute.
Do you?
Hello, Baron.
Who wants to make a buck? Poor little guy.
He wants to make a buck. When doesn't he want to make a buck? That's what I heard.
It's a cute radio voice.
Wow. He's milling about, and he can't even look at us. Sam's laughing at him. Ooh. Well, E-Rock, just shake your head or nod your head. Is there another copy? Without being on to anything, yes or no, I won't say a word. I just wanted to know.
Let's just say on that copy there, is there more gems? So yes. More gems.
I got the whole thing is gems. Every time
that voice comes on,
I'm selling fudgy wudgy bars, and then Bear Man just laughs like he can't believe it. That's outrageous.
Like, oh God, what is Spuds up to today?
Oh, Spuds is always up to something. Let's bring him in. Uh-oh, here he comes.
How come, I'm just curious, though. How come Spuds was like, la-la-la-la? Like, why would Spuds make that noise?
Yeah, why would he sing a little la-la song?
Like, I know he wants to make a buck. I understand that.
Have you decompressed enough?
La-la-la-la-la-la-la-la.
Have you cooled off enough to talk? He turns... Clean it up! You guinea brat!
I can't stop pinching my cock.
All right, with that, we'll do line of the day.
Here comes line of the day. Line of the day.
Oh, what a beautiful day.
Oh, God, I got a good night. Oh, my God, they all know I had sex with a hooker.
Fudgy wudgy bars.
Oh, fudgy wudgy bars. Cute.
Fudgy wudgy bars.
What?
As one of Opie's characters called Spuds Buckley when he was very, very young and starting in radio, and it's... probably amongst the worst things you'll ever hear in your life.
I never heard Opie do characters.
Oh, it's great. And well, you shouldn't after Spuds Buckley.
Spuds Buckley?
It is so bad.
How bad is it?
How would you describe Spuds Buckley? He's kind of this
childish thing.
With a wacky little voice like this and comes in going, la, 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 la.
He's based on a waterhead.
Yeah.
Certainly, yeah.
Oh, is that it?
He thinks he's smarter than he really is.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'll not shy. I'll sum up Spuds Buckley. Thinks he's cool. When Voss opened those diapers, if it had spoken. La, la, la. It's kind of like Jerry Lewis.
Yeah, there's a bunch of...
Good morning, Batman.
I hate you.
I'm going to get Spuds down.
All right, I'll bring in the disc tomorrow.
But why is the disc not here with the rest of the
disc? I really
disc?
Just truly forgot it today.
Why'd you bring it home?
You know. Because I have to control how much Spuds Buckley gets out there.
He's
why?
Embarrassing.
I'm embarrassed. But it's 15 years ago, Otto.
It is, really?
What were you doing 15 years ago?
You know, doing my act.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Banging my girlfriend at the time.
Yeah. Waking up on a floor somewhere.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
La, 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 la.
Oh, no.
Good morning, Bearman.
Oh.
That was Spuds Buckley's voice.
Oh. La la, yeah, look. See, Otto can't even, like, fathom that shit.
Yeah.
It's just like, yeah.
Why would he go la la la?
Because I told you I was all about the catchphrase. I was dreaming that everyone would be doing the la 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 la.
I'd rather have two of Otto's cameras and hold them tight against my ears and just hear, bah!
Ugh, Spuds Buckley's a douche.
Yes.
He's the worst. Right, now I'm sad, so we should
Spuds Buckley's going to rue the day that the time machine's invented.
That's right.
The day it's invented, you get to go back in time and punch him in the face.
Oh, yeah, I will.
With brass
worst
knuckles.
Idea since clear Pepsi.
Thanks, Otto. Thanks for helping.
Yeah.
Yeah, there you go. Let's go to Patrick on Long Island. Patrick, what's up?
La, 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 la. Good morning, LB.
Jesus.
And put all the rest of you people, you go straight to break the
Thanks, Drew. We're back with the Opie and Anthony show. That's audio from a character I used to do 15 years ago at this point.
Do you still know how to do it?
No, no. Of course he does. No. No.
I mean, listen.
No, no, no.
You don't know?
No.
You don't
know? No.
You forgot?
This was like in the early 90s when I was working in Buffalo Fox, which is now The Edge.
What's the character's name?
Spuds Buckley.
Spuds Buckley.
How did he start out, though? Like, how did
with
it,
brain damage?
How did he start out?
Yeah, how did it come to you? Like, how did you go?
I was an overnight DJ desperate for attention. I invented this character and brought it to a morning show, and, you know, they kind of went with it.
They went with Spuds Buckley?
I don't know why.
Three different morning shows did.
How did
I was a staple for three morning shows.
And what did Spuds do? Like, what was his thing?
He was not shy. He was very naive. He was full of energy.
Boy, you make him sound almost endearing instead of completely annoying.
See, that's the beauty of it. See, yes, he was very annoying, but he didn't know he was annoying.
Mm-hmm.
Based on my real personality, obviously.
Yeah.
And you forgot how to do them, though?
Yeah.
Doesn't still live in your heart somewhere?
No, my voice changed. I forgot all about this dumb thing and the
just kind of stumbled upon it a year or two ago and went, oh, my God, that's right. I used to do this thing.
Spuds Buckley.
Dude, I was making $12,000 a year. Give me a break.
That was a lot back then, though.
$12,000 a year, and I would do midnight to 6 on the radio, and then I would do 6 to 10 with the morning show. Not the whole morning, but I would come in and do my thing wasn't getting them coffee and donuts.
Who would do the morning, Spuds or you?
Bearman. Then they hired some dude from L.A., some, like, stud from L.A. that used to do weather or something, but he was in radio. I think his name is Garth Hemp or Guy Hemp. I don't know. I think there's two of them. I think Garth Hemp, and he had one of these voices, and he came to Buffalo. And I, as a little, like, kid, like, just getting started in broadcast, I'm like, hey, I got this character. We don't need you, kid.
Really?
Oh, yeah. He hated Spuds Buckley.
Who wouldn't?
Did you do it for him, like, off air? Like in?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Like,
yeah.
Just in a blank studio? With.
Oh,
so
yeah.
Here's the character now yeah. I'd like to do for you. It's Spuds Buckley.
Yeah.
Let me just get into character. You turn around.
Yeah.
And then you turn back.
Yeah.
And you're Spuds.
Now, here's the deal. We're going on vacation,
mm-hmm.
taking a little over a week off. And when we get back, we'll do the whole Spuds Buckley thing.
But I want to hear it.
No, I'm going to give you a little something today.
Oh, something new?
Yes. But right. When we get back, this is the big get. Oh, you'll be chatting about it on message boards. Oh, only 4 more days before we get to hear more Spuds Buckley.
Will they?
I think one of my taste buds just died.
Wow, I can't believe they teased this. Oh, my God. I don't know what I'm going to do for the next week until they come back and give me more Spuds Buckley. Stupid thing is taking on a life of its own. And I haven't even found my cassette where I have all of Spuds Buckley's appearances.
Oh, well.
Including songs I used to write and sing.
Songs you would sing?
Oh, yeah, I got
you would
it.
Sing songs of Spuds Buckley.
Well, you know, when I was in Buffalo doing radio, you know, the Bills were in the Super Bowl every freaking year.
You didn't sing a Bills song, did you?
Oh, yeah.
You You wrote a Bills song and sang it as Spuds Buckley. And you have a recording of this, and we haven't heard it.
Yeah.
No, I really got to find it, because I have hundreds and hundreds of cassettes that I'm still unloading in my apartment. And
look at the one labeled.
No. That's the problem. A lot of the labels have fallen off these cassettes, so I got to go through them one at a time.
It's
a pain in the ass, but we'll get there. But
that one, just pick it up and smell them. The one that stinks the most is it.
The big hook in my Super Bowl song might have been, it's Super Bowl Sunday. But done in the Spuds Buckley voice.
Oh, my God, no.
You know, it didn't have yuck on it. It had great.
Like, oh, yeah.
Go to.
Good stuff. The good stuff.
Numero uno.
All right, listen. I will play you a clip here. And then we save the rest for after break. But we'll give you a little more Spuds Buckley today.
Mm-hmm.
Spuds Buckley!
Boo!
Yes.
Let it be noted that I am hitting the boo button on myself.
You
yes.
should not be able to hit the boo button.
Yes.
You have to just take it. No buttons.
Oh, what I would do to Spuds Buckley if I could find that damn time machine.
Oh, the time machine, yeah.
Oh, boy.
You got to go back and just punch him so hard. Just blindside him.
Oh, boy, would I.
Brass knuckles to the side of the face.
Absolutely.
And he wouldn't even know. He's like, what are you doing? You go like, I'm you from the future, idiot.
I think
you're
being
a jerk.
I think if I could go back in a time machine, I would get Spuds Buckley addicted to heroin.
But then you would be so strung out that when you reach the point now, you would be probably destitute. You wouldn't have access to a time machine, so it never would have happened.
Oh. Yeah, but...
But then you'd be fine, and you'd be able to do it.
But I also...
Then if you did it...
But also I want to rape him and punch him in the face and all these other things. So what does that mean for the current day oopster?
It would screw you up so badly that you would never be able to go in the time machine to go back and screw yourself up. So you'd be normal.
So this whole time machine thing, if I go back and meet Spuds Buckley, I have to kind of give him encouragement?
What
is that? I want to go back and beat the crap out of this kid.
No, because if you're able to go back,
right.
It means that you couldn't have done those horrible things to him. Because then you'd be so screwed up that you wouldn't be able to go back.
Don't ruin my time machine bit.
Sorry, it's a paradox.
Yeah,
I hate those paradox with time travel. Just can't wrap your mind around it.
All right, well.
Sucks.
Well, listen, way before Anthony and I did our famous April Fool's prank that got us fired the first time.
Oh, yes.
My second radio, by the way. Because we all got fired when we were working in Buffalo back in the day because they, you know, were bought out. But anyway.
Spuds Buckley didn't save the day?
No. There was a morning show, The Bear Man. He's now heard in Allentown, Pennsylvania.
I know.
Morning, Bear Man.
And his April Fool's prank was to come up with a parade. And then people would call the station, like, wow, where's this parade? It sounds cool. Mm-hmm. I want to check it out with my kids. Well, the gag is there was never a parade, but it sounded like there was an actual parade going through Buffalo. And I was part of that bit that day.
Ooh.
As Spuds Buckley.
The Fox Buffalo's home of quality rock and roll. Hey, 636. Gracious, good morning. You're on your way with the Bear Man. We've got the whole Fox crew. We're here at the... At the reviewing stand for the first annual Fox Fools Parade. We're located just 1/2 mile west of Furman Boulevard near Shooters, and they're still working on getting...
So you give the location, and all of a sudden people show up and like, hey, where's the parade?
And there's sound effects like they're building a reviewing stand or something. Is that what they're doing, or a float? What are they building?
Yeah.
As you're on it, what is this, Animal House?
Yeah, what is the hammering in the background? Unless it's Spuds Buckley's head.
We're creating an illusion.
Spud Buckley's.
All you need is a hammer sound, you know, hammering a nail in, and you create an illusion.
Illusion.
Yes.
Theater of the mind.
That's right.
Furman Boulevard near Shooters, and they're still working on getting some of the barriers.
Some of these vendors we got over here, they want to know where the hell they're supposed to be.
Vendors. Where's let's look at the paper. Well,
la 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 la.
All right, listen.
You got it.
Please,
you got it.
Please, Bobby.
Just relish in it.
Please.
What?
For the love of everything that's holy, push that button.
What happened?
That was, you heard 2 seconds of Spuds Buckley, and now you just want to hear as much as you can.
You haven't heard Spuds Buckley yet?
No, but did he have a hat with a propeller on top?
See? It was that type of character.
I didn't create this character be, like, cool.
Oh.
It wasn't getting me the Buffalo Bettys.
You were like the Nutty Professor. Like one guy was like la 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 la, and then the other one was Buddy Love, the crooner.
You had buck teeth in your pocket and Chinese, like Asian guy glasses.
Dude,
let me tell you something.
La, 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 la. And I would do a lot of stuff out in the streets, and I was too poor to get the proper outfit for Spuds Buckley. So I would just like come up with stuff. Like the pictures that are up on onaradio.com. That's me as Spuds Buckley. See, there's really nothing that makes me look like the character I'm playing.
No, of course not.
Wait a minute.
Yeah, look at it and soak it in.
I have sweatpants, and white basketball sneakers, and the sweatpants are tucked into the white socks that are pulled up pretty high. And then I got the station jacket on because it is Buffalo and I'm freezing my ass off. And then I have like a do-rag on.
And are you making a la 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 face?
No, I'm doing a what's up, man, face.
Oh my
All right.
God!
All right, let's play this.
Let's look at the paper. Well,
la 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 la.
No.
Good morning, Bear Man.
Ladies and gentlemen, put them together for Spuds Buckley.
Put them together. Yeah. Two mallets with his head between it.
You have to stop. My ears almost fell off. Yeah. The dew shivers just went up my back.
Right?
Almost shook my ears off.
Right?
Yeah.
You
got to remember, I was making 12 G's. This is... I'm being
12
polite.
Large, huh?
I'm being polite. This was at least 15 years ago. No, about 15 years ago.
You should have been
90s.
Making... Governor Spitzer prostitute money to degrade yourself like that.
And I actually I told the story. I was supposed to show up at a really nice outdoor club in Buffalo at Spuds Buckley, and I'm there, and there's all these these hot chicks and guys trying to pick up the hot chicks, and then I was supposed to be like the entertainment and do a couple things and sell some beers. And I sat in my car and basically cried and said, I can't do this.
Cried?
I can't do this. Dude, I have suffered in this business. And I never showed up. And it was a big client. I believe it was like Budweiser or something. I mean, it was a huge client. And I almost got fired. And then I actually did cry in the general manager's office. I'm like, look,
oh my God.
You can't fire me. I just couldn't do this. I was mortified.
You had a life-changing moment in the
car
as Spuds Buckley?
In my Honda Accord that had close to 200,000 miles on it.
Did you go
in
home?
The parking lot of this really hip club that I was supposed to like make this big appearance as Spuds Buckley.
Did you go home that night and take the outfit off and fold it up and put it in a suitcase and put it up on the top shelf of a closet?
I think that's how this whole character ended. I don't think I did it after that because I just
kind of petered out.
The salespeople, they'll sell anything. They're like, the Spuds Buckley character.
Apparently.
We gotta have him doing appearances all over Buffalo. And the first one, I sat in the parking lot with my dumb, awful outfit that I had next to me on the passenger seat. And I'm like, I can't do this. I will not do this. And I'm pounding the steering wheel. My life sucks. I'm 400 miles away from home trying to make something of myself in radio.
Oh.
And then it got back to the GM. I didn't show up, and rumor had it that he was just going to fire me flat out, and I actually had to let the tears flow to make sure I didn't get fired.
You used
true
the
story.
Bitch get out of a ticket strategy.
Hell yeah, man. Not only did I not get fired, I got a raise.
You got a raise?
Yeah, because I told him how down on my luck I was, making no money, you know, far from home. I was collecting change to eat. But anyway...
I don't like that he's pulling on a heartstring.
I know, he's trying to get some sympathy now.
I'm just giving you some background on this whole thing.
I don't care if you cried in your car and you couldn't eat and you had to go down on people to get a meal. You did Spuds la 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 la.
Right, hey, good morning, man.
Do you
want
to hear more or what?
Come on. Not only do I want to hear more, I have to.
All right, here we go.
I'm here to make a buck this morning.
Spuds, when aren't you here to make a buck, huh?
Hey.
So do you have your vendor permit?
I'll trust
you, okay?
Okay.
Now you gonna be vending up and down the parade route today?
I'm gonna be selling fudgy wudgy bars this morning.
Bobby's leaving. Bobby just got up.
Bobby!
He's physically leaving.
Bobby just left. That means we can't play anymore, I guess.
He's leaving.
Too bad. I was willing to give you another 30 seconds today. And he left. He left the studio, and I can't... You
know. I need to hear more, because, like I said, I want new Spuds Buckley. Everything so far, I've heard already.
Uh-huh.
I need just something a little new.
Well...
I'm sorry. I'm sorry I had to go punch something.
Bobby, why do you think I'm, like, the biggest dick... Because I've been through the freaking ringer in this business.
Oh, wait a minute. E-Rex got a Spuds Buckley song?
What?
We represent the lollipop kids, the lollipop
kids,
the lollipop
kids. Wow. Sounds just like him.
Yeah, you might laugh, but you know, I was the inspiration for SpongeBob SquarePants.
That is true.
Drew. I could have been making SpongeBob SquarePants money.
You got to play some more. I need new Spuds Buckley for the next break.
Oh, yeah.
See? Just in case you thought I was lying, listen to this.
Uh-oh.
Many years later, this is what was going on in pop culture. I was on to something, my friends.
Yeah, you were on.
See?
That's from SpongeBob SquarePants.
Yeah. I was on to something.
Yeah, you were.
About 10 years later, all of a sudden, they're ripping off Spuds Buckley. Where's my residuals? I need residuals. Why do you think I'm a dick, dude? I've done it all in this business. Aunt knows. I freaking had to sit on the side of the Long Island Expressway at a gas station pumping a $1.02 gas and handing roses to fatties for Valentine's Day. I've done it all.
Oh,
I've had it. I've done the jello wrestling in parking lots and stupid kiddie pools.
This is such a backstory of how Opie became Opie.
Absolutely. And I was the guy, you don't mind. Let him work every holiday. Oh, God, that's why I'm a dick, if you really want to get into it. I've seen it all, my
get
friend.
Get into it.
I had to do two for Tuesdays, and I had to get the lead out. And I did Mandatory Metallica. And I did the Foreplay Weekend where the fourth cut is always live. That was me!
Of course it is.
Who do you think was spinning the tunes for your Block Party Weekend? Me! Who ran the 5 o'clock funnies? Me!
5 o'clock, I've done those.
Oh. Freeway Jam?
Yeah, the 5 o'clock traffic jam.
Yeah.
Well, you get some jamming too. That was me, Bob.
He's having a nervous breakdown.
That's why I'm a dick.
Anthony, scared. Anthony's doing iPhone, pal talk, and AIM all at once right now. He's getting scared.
I'm petrified by Opie.
He's multitasking. I'm glad I'm not the only one.
No.
What?
Now, first of all, Bob Kelly.
Yes, sir.
Is a rat. Bob Kelly is a rat.
But we all know, though, dude.
If
he's just the one
up,
bringing it to everyone's attention.
If I don't care, then why are you bringing it up?
Anthony, I'm
just to be a rat.
Because
you're a rat. You're a goddamn Italian, and you're ratting on another guinea.
Listen,
you're a rat.
Let me just tell you, Anthony, because you look over and you got not. If you had eight hands, you'd have something electronic in all eight hands. Okay?
Yeah, one would be vibrating, and you'd be impaled on it. Rat Fink Bob Kelly.
Because Anthony, you're right in front of me.
You'd be
like
shanked in prison in a second. Wow. In a second. You hear Bob? Yeah, he's a rat.
Yeah. All right, listen. Let me
rats.
All right. I won't.
All family's rats.
Let's go to Jason in Carolina. Jason, what's up?
Hey, poor Opie. He's gone through all this radio hell, and what was he doing a week ago? Rubbing baby crap under his nose. Nothing's changed for you, man.
Nah, that's true.
You're right.
I'm still Spuds Buckley deep down.
I'll always be him.
It's okay, Opie. Relax.
It's okay.
It's okay.
It was just this is the beginning. It was the way you got into, you know, the business.
Who do you think played the songs when we did the 9 to 5 promotion? Listen to a song in the 9 o'clock hour. Listen to one in the 2 o'clock hour. Listen to the one in the 5 o'clock hour. Be the 10th caller, and you win this crappy prize. That was me!
I'm scared.
Very.
Done every dumb promotion available.
Very frightening. Very frightening.
We still love you, though.
He's nervous.
Who started Led Zeppelin A to Z? I started with the first song. The Firecracker 500. That was me!
Firecracker 500. That's 4th of July weekend, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Who do you think had a sleep at the radio station the 4th of July weekend? Me! While you're out there barbecuing and drinking and picking up broads. I had to make believe this Firecracker 500 thing was important.
Oh, guess what the number one song of all time is going to be? Oh, is it going to be Stairway to Heaven? Oh, maybe it'll be Freebird this time around.
That was me! I had to make believe it mattered.
What?
Oh, he's throwing things. He's all angry.
Dude, he's not even throwing things that won't hurt. He threw a coffee mug.
Oh, Jesus. Big, heavy Starbucks one.
It's a big, heavy Starbucks. Who threw that?
Who had to deliver the big... the big 6 foot heroes and the pizza to the office parks. I actually did that.
I remember that.
I did that at BAB where I thought I was actually, you know, finally doing something with my career, and like one of my jobs was I had to like get the 6 foot hero and go to an office park in the middle of nowhere. And all of a sudden I'm in this office and no one gives a crap. They just want the free sub. Then no one knew who I was, and I'm handing out T-shirts and ice scrapers, and I see a kid I graduate with, and he's like, why are you bringing me lunch? I'm like, yeah, that's me. Remember when I had this dream of going into broadcasting when we were in history class together? Well, this is what it's become 10 years later.
Well, like the guy said, though, I mean, you did make it. You're on a great hit show. And
well, back then.
Well, right now, though, you did. You made it.
It's just embarrassing back then.
Yeah.
Actually, you know it wasn't. It was actually cool. Honey, guess what I did today? I went down to this big office park, and I brought ice scrapers, and everybody was glad to see me because it was icy out.
Because it was icy out. Brought a sandwich, and it was great because everyone was kind of hungry.
Dude, there was a crowd, and I just threw T-shirts into them. It was nuts. They were going nuts. And I'd wait, and then I'd throw it, and they'd go,
they love me.
Oh, they love me, man. The guy gave me his card. He gave me his card. He told me to give him a call. He might want me to promote something as Spuds Buckley. La, 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 la.
Let me say hi to Lydia from Oceanside.
Mm-hmm.
Hi, Elsie.
Hi, Lydia.
You know, last time I spoke to you, you said you would never, ever see a therapist. But I hear so much anguish in your voice about your past. I wonder if you wouldn't reconsider.
So you think I need a therapist?
I'm just suggesting that you may.
Well, I think you need a big black dick up your ass.
Whoa!
What's going on?
I certainly hope someone's being attentive. I certainly hope someone's being attentive down the hall. Opie certainly gave her a fine how do you do. Wow.
Jeez. Where are we?
Yeah.
Anthony, where
frequency modulation, Opie. We are on frequency modulation. You must wait until this signal is beamed into outer space and returns back to Earth, cleansed in the atmosphere.
Yeah.
What? Oh, man, this is the day.
Oof.
This is the, you know, Jimmy's nervous somewhere.
Chick. It's always before vacation.
Jimmy's nervous somewhere. He's going, not today, not today.
Wow, I certainly hope. I've had it with that Lydia crap.
Could you see if he was... Could you see if the guy down the hall is just like, I gotta go to the bathroom just for 2 seconds. And he's in there and he hears that. Blah! He's running with a turtle poking out.
He's wagging a tail like Lassie.
Right, right. Yeah, well.
Running down the hallway, tripping over his own jeans, they're around his ankles, falls on his face, misses the button.
When we get back, first this, listen.
If we get back.
I'll trust you, okay?
Okay.
Now, you're gonna be vending up and down the parade route today?
I'm going to be selling fudgy wudgy bars this morning. And I got a slogan.
Yeah, he's got a slogan.
This slogan...
Why does that make
not only
angry?
Will be played after the break...
Oh.
You will be discussing this while we're on vacation, you'll be discussing
the slogan?
This.
I'm making a t-shirt of it.
Yeah, please.
I want t-shirts made.
All right, this...
You know what? You should give this this audio right to Coke Logic so he could, like, animate me selling Fudgy Wudgy bars as Spuds Buckley.
Already people are guessing.
Guessing it's, the slogan?
I take it in the A.
I guarantee that you can come up with a better slogan than what you're about to hear after the break. As far as...
Stupid?
As far as... Just cringing your ass off. As far as, like, hair standing up all over your body.
Oh, God.
I'm frightened at this slogan.
Oh, let's do Battle of the Bands.
Did you write it?
Who do you think's going to win tonight? It's Aerosmith, and they're going up against Kansas.
Well,
call our request line and vote for your favorite band so we can move on with the bracket.
Dude, I gotta go with Aerosmith over Kansas. They're a lot more relevant now, I think. So I'm gonna say Aerosmith.
Okay, I'll put the one vote down for Aerosmith.
All right, thanks, man. You rock. Boo, boo, boo!
All right, thank you.
Thank you. Linger longer. Won't be saying that for a few years, but believe me, it'll hurt.
Hello, you're listening to The Opie Show. I don't even know why I say my name, because all I'm doing is Sagan Records. What can I do for you?
Yeah, can you play the latest from the Black Crowes?
Sure, okay, I'll do that. Oh, I'm going to get to talk for 20 seconds soon. Ooh, I have to read a liner note. Say my name, say the weather, and get back into tunes. Ooh. Ooh, this was worth years and years away from home!
You wonder why he steps on homeless people's cakes.
I'm trying to figure out. Yeah, people are saying, Ant, it couldn't possibly be as bad as the Burly Bear Show.
Thank you, sir, whoever wrote that.
This is Robert Kelly.
It was we'll be Jaster.
We'll be back in just a bit.
Spuds Buckley.
So please. Where were we?
We were at the slogan, I believe. You were at a parade, I believe.
A fake parade, because...
A fake parade.
Because this stuff really works on the radio.
Yeah, and you showed up, and of course they're like, oh, here he comes. Oh, watch out, Spuds is here.
Yeah.
And...
here comes the funny.
Yeah, here comes the funny. Strap in. And
I was penciled in for 7:20 a.m. How you like them apples? Most listened to part of a morning show.
Of course.
What time is it now?
And let's see, you needed a vendor's license because you were going to be selling fudgy wudgy bars.
Yes. What the hell is fudgy wudgy bar?
It's a thing I picked up by going to the beaches out there on Long Island. They would walk around going fudgy wudgy bars. That was my inspiration. But they had deeper voices.
Yeah.
Before we play more Spuds Buckley, I want to play three songs. You, the listener, have to guess. What is the common theme of these three songs?
Oh, wow.
That was me!
He's got to snap this.
And then you start with Rush Trees. Oh, boy, I don't know. It's going to have something to do with the woods? I don't know.
Trees or the woods?
I'll have to wait for the second song.
Second song?
Ugh.
Now, did you...
Workforce blocks, noontime blocks. That was me. Me.
When did you stop playing records and just started talking?
Actually, it started...
W.
No, it started... Well, yeah, there was music as a theme running through us until we got to NEW, right?
Yeah.
But just started messing around was when I was in Buffalo, because I did overnights and the PD was sleeping, so I knew I could get away with bloody murder.
And we didn't even say, or the boss didn't even say, okay, you guys are doing a talk show now. Stop playing music. We just stopped playing music.
We finally had it.
We stopped playing. Well, the PD was like, you know, huh, what?
That leads to the Carol Miller tapes. If you remind me after break, we should play the Carol Miller tapes for the newbies out there. Because that explains, we were in the middle of this huge thing they put together, and we're like, you know what, we F this music. So we started making fun of it and playing baseball with the records and stuff. And
we were actually, I think it was Rod Stewart's If You Want My Body and You Think I'm Sexy.
Right.
Was that the one?
Oh, yeah.
And then... We played baseball with it.
Yeah.
Just smashed it.
Yeah.
Because who the hell wants to hear that?
And then we just decided we refused to play the next record to the point where the GM came in and he's looking at us like, what are you guys doing?
Very angry.
And I'm like, I'm not pushing that button. And Ant's like, I'm not pushing that button.
Why? Why would
we? And it was just uncomfortable for everybody. And then there was like a cleaning lady literally like vacuuming the studio while we're trying to do our show and we made her do it. Like, let her effing do it. I'm amazed we didn't get fired. I'm amazed. We were such idiots. We should have got fired years before we did.
Oh, hell yeah.
Years. They got the Carol Miller in front of me, but we got to wait till after break for that. Just remind us of this story we're setting up today. Trust me, it's a good listen, because we went at it with her. She believed in the old days. We believed in the new days. At one point, you took all the CDs in a box and were giving away the world's largest rock library to people on the street.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, I forgot about that.
They would always talk about how their rock library was the biggest in the world, and we're like, you know, it just all sucks, though, so we're just going to start giving it away. And, we just was giving away albums, classic albums, and vinyl
signed by
CDs.
Zeppelin and stuff. We didn't care.
Just giving it away until we were told to stop immediately.
You gave away stuff that should be in the Rock and Roll Hall.
Oh, absolutely, yeah. It was horrible.
Did you say Rock and Hall?
I'm amazed. They must have saw something in us, because... I'm being reminded of something else. E-Rock tells me, and I do remember this. We started breaking Bruce Springsteen CDs every day. Every day we'd destroy the catalog, and they would get so mad, and then a new catalog would be there the next day when we start our show. We would destroy it again.
Good for you.
And I can't believe we didn't get fired for this.
I can't believe that.
Bruce Springsteen reminds me of Jewish camp.
Why Jewish camp?
I worked at a Jewish camp for one summer. That's all they played.
Oh, okay.
Stupid.
I'm getting yelled at. We got to go to Spuds Buckley. We're starting way too many storylines. The beauty of this show, we'll finish those storylines after our little vacation. Trust me, you're going to want to hear the Carol Miller tapes if you haven't heard them yet. But first, Spuds Buckley, something I did 15 years ago in Buffalo. Not proud of it whatsoever.
The Fox Buffalo's home of quality. Rock
we'll start over again in case people are just tuning
in. Good morning. You're on your way with the Bear Man. We got the whole Fox crew. We're here at the... At the reviewing stand for the first annual Fox Fools Parade. We're located just 1/2 mile west of Furman Boulevard.
There's Anthony in the background,
and they're still working on getting some of the barriers.
Some of these vendors we got over here, they want to know where the hell they're supposed to be.
Vendors. Where's let's look at the page. Well,
la 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 la.
Oh, no.
Good morning, Bearman.
Ladies and gentlemen, put them together for Spuds Buckley.
Oh,
I got the big intro, though.
Spuds a Buckley!
Spuds a Buckley!
Why did he say it like that? I don't understand.
That was the big get for this morning show.
I know.
That was the big get.
No.
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 No. I couldn't be.
No, 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 no.
Buckley! I'm here to make a buck this morning.
Spuds, when aren't you here to make a buck, huh?
Hey.
So do you have your finger permit?
Hey.
All right. Yeah. I'll trust you. Okay.
Okay.
Now you're gonna be vending up and down the parade route today.
I'm gonna be selling fudgy wudgy bars this morning. And I got a slogan.
I can't.
Oh, yeah. Oh.
A buck first.
Yeah. Okay. Thanks very much, Spuds. Now why don't you go vend somewhere else, huh?
All right. It's cold. Fudgy bars. Fudgy.
Hey, Spuds. Wait. Before you go away. Now, are those cold fudgy wudgy bars or are they warm ones?
Well, I heated them up in the microwave this morning.
There you go, buddy. All right.
See, because I was always getting everything wrong.
Of course you were.
And I don't know why they wouldn't let us say a buck for a suck was the
was
slogan.
That it?
Yeah.
Was that your slogan?
I don't know why they...
You got the suck right. God damn it. That is
really just... I don't even know what to say about that.
If I met you back then, Opie...
Oh.
Yeah.
Fudgy wudgy bars.
If
I was doing radio to do a comedy and you walked in, hey, Bob, Robert Kelly, this is Spuds Buckley.
Why did you
So if you met me back then, what?
I would want to throw something
you
at
you. You
would
have said no to second oh.
Boo!
Can't even do a fat joke right.
Why did you put the fudgy wudgy bars in the microwave?
Because you're not supposed to.
Yeah, see, the whole bit was that I was messing up everything.
I
was a lovable, naive little thing that was getting everything wrong. And he kept me around because, he kind of felt bad for me.
Yeah, well, I could see that.
Yeah.
That's the part I could definitely see.
Yeah. Oh, I explain why in the next clip. What?
Yeah.
What?
You explain why you put it in the microwave in the next
clip. Oh.
Hang on, let me just shake the dew shivers off from the last one.
All right, we'll give you a little more.
I hear that.
A little more, and then the rest has to be for after vacation.
And this is where it all started.
No.
This is where it all started.
No.
No, I was already doing radio for, six years before this even.
I'm not even talking about that. I'm talking about this is where it all started when you snapped.
It definitely started at BAB a little bit, but when Ant and I moved to Boston, then it was game on, man. I finally had it with everybody in this dumb business and how ridiculous it really is.
But you knew that was in the closet somewhere. Did you ever be doing your show now, successful now, and doing meeting the fans, and just in the back of your head, you know... It's like you ever do something with your friend of yours when you're a kid by accident at his house or at a sleepover, and then you're with a hot chick later in your life, and you're like, wow, if she knew what I did with that kid, with my buddy.
What the hell is wrong with you?
Do you ever think about Spudsy Wudsy like
your
that?
Spudsy Wudsy.
He's a Spudsy Wudsy. He put Spuds and Fudgy Wudgy together.
You have a Spudsy Wudsy?
F out of here.
Do you ever like a bunch of fans and they think you're cool?
Look, let me tell you something. And this is a life lesson for everybody out there. No one starts off being cool.
What about Steven Seagal?
Not a one.
Steven Seagal.
He came right out of
the... You can make all the fun you want. We were playing your old tapes recently. There's not a person alive that starts off cool, except for maybe Mick Jagger.
Yeah.
Maybe. Not even John Lennon. Look at the silly haircut he had back in the day.
Yeah, true.
Elvis.
No one starts off cool.
Elvis.
Well, I'd have to look into that, but you might have got me.
And Steven Seagal did come out of the game above the law.
How about this? Most people don't start off cool.
Most people.
They really don't. They got to find themselves, and they got to hone their craft.
James Dean came out cool.
Steve McQueen.
Steve McQueen came out cool. John Wayne, cool.
All right.
Robert Duvall, cool. Tommy Lee Jones, cool.
Do you want to know why Spuds was putting him in the microphone?
Yes.
I do explain this, E-Rock?
A little bit, yeah.
Of course.
A little bit. All right. This is all you're going to get for today, and I'll save the rest.
It's the first annual Fox Fools Parade. We're located 1/2 mile west of Furman Boulevard, right near Shooters. Plenty of free parking in the Shooters parking lot.
La 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 la. Get
Spuds.
Your
Spuds. Spuds Buckley, ladies and Spuds. How's it going with the sales of the Fudgy Wudgy bars?
Well, the buck first suck ain't working so well, so we're gonna throw all this in the microwave and we're gonna start selling hot cocoa on a stick. Get your hot cocoa on a stick here. La la la.
Well, we just about have the reviewing stand completely finished. They're just putting the bunting up.
Anthony, if you get up and walk right now, I'll go with you.
I
will go with you, dude.
That's fine. I could do. I could go back to doing CQ 102, hit music and more. No problem. That was me.
I just lost my.
Here's
like
your Genesee
will.
Valley forecast. All right.
Anthony lost his will. His arms are hanging by his head. Like
I'm stunned. Cocoa on a stick.
Hot cocoa on a stick.
Hey, it got a big laugh. It got a big laugh.
Certainly did. You got to give Spuds that.
From a guy who's the king of Allentown, but still, it's a big laugh.
La 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 la.
Hello, Batman. Good morning, Batman.
Batman.
Wow.
You know, I haven't even attempted to do that voice. Even in the shower by myself, I can't even, like, muster up.
But.
The bravery to be with myself and attempt to see if I can
just
even do
it
that
would
again.
Be self embarrassing.
Can I ask you a question seriously, Opie? Mm. You really don't remember how to do that voice?
I could probably do it in a second.
Oh.
Swear to God, I've not tried. You think at this point in the shower at 4 a.m. when no one's around, I would attempt this?
Everyone's heard it, so now just give it a try.
Just a shot.
Just try.
Just a shot. Just to let us hear to see what it would
just
sound
do
like.
Just do the la 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 part.
You know what I'm willing to do? I really think that we should revive the Spuds Buckley character. But you know how there's a new like Fred Flintstone and there's a new Darren.
Darren Stevens, yeah, right, from like, Bewitched.
They keep the character alive with a new person. Maybe I'll have the guys like try out to be the new Spuds Buckley.
Oh,
that's what I do.
That is.
That's why I'm the radio genius.
I think you might.
That's how you could keep the bit going.
I just want to see if you.
How about we have after the vacation?
Uh huh.
Yeah, and we have to force these guys to do it. At least most of them. They all have to audition to be Spuds Buckley.
Oh,
you have
God.
A little over a week to come up with some kind of Spuds Buckley material
it's
that you
gotta
have
be.
To audition. Live on this show when we get back from vacation.
And it has to be an equal level of humor, the bit. Don't try to be too funny.
No, I think if they're funny, that's fine.
Yeah, I think it'll ruin the illusion.
Well, what I did is, you know, no one's going to forget anytime soon. But
well, of course. Classic.
E-Rock, are you willing to try out to be the new Spuds Buckley?
I'll try.
Spuds Buckley 08, we'll call him.
I think wow. Sam, I think Sam's going to be
Sam, the winner. Will you try? Sam, thumbs up. Yeah, if you have any sarcasm in your impression, I will punch you so hard in the face.
Wow.
There's going to be rules.
This is like when they make a movie out of an old TV show.
Right.
And you got a new guy.
Right. We are auditioning for the new Spuds Buckley.
I took a popsicle and put it in a microwave and made Kool-Aid. La, 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 la.
Oh, look at that.
And,
we have a winner.
You know, and then maybe we open it up to the listeners. Sure.
Oh, they get
but
to-
we start with the staff. And then if maybe in the middle of this whole thing, if I'm feeling it, maybe.
Oh, like
please.
On American Idol when they bring out the actual artist that the singers are singing.
Or when they make a movie out of the TV show and then the old star like makes an
cameo,
appearance as
right.
somebody else. But maybe I'll just be like, I don't know, Spuds Buckley's father in this new production
go.
Or something.
So you'll come in and go, Spuds, what are you doing in the living room? La 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 la.
I am chilling.
That's
chilling over here.
Travis, you going to try one? Thumbs up from Travis, Danny. All right.
Yeah.
Dan,
everyone's
even?
In.
Dan's going to be too sarcastic and dry.
I'm Spuds Buckley.
La, 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 la.
La, la, la.
My,
I hate my mother.
I only blink once an hour. I look like a painting from the 18th century.
All right. Don't forget. That's the first thing we do when we come back from vacation. I say we run a promo even.
What?
Actually do work?
A what?
A what?
Hey.
And then I got new, I do have other Spuds Buckley audio. We got another 2 or 3 minutes here, and then I got to find some more stuff.
It's gold.
It's magic.
It is.
Yeah.
It's magic.
Is
dude.
It?
It really is.
Is it?
to see the evolution of Ope.
Is it?
Ope.
Is it?
Now, let me ask you, you haven't done that voice since then.
Swear to God. I pretty much forgot about it.
Since that lonely, crying night in the car when you're punching the steering wheel.
I believe that was it. If that wasn't it, shortly after that, it was done. Oh, yeah.
Oh, my God.
Oh, yeah. I was ready to quit radio. I was going to... The fact is, I was going to go out west and, like
kill yourself?
I was going to be, like, a, like work at a...
A rodeo clown?
No, I was going to work at a ski resort. I was done with radio, yeah. And then I saw an ad in the trades for, like, the a night jock at BAB, and I was like, what the hell? And I actually wasn't even going to send the tape because Buffalo was having a huge blizzard.
Yeah.
And I ran down to the FedEx office in this blizzard. True story, because you couldn't get a cab or a car anywhere near there, so I had to get there. Because they were going to make their decision for this gig. And sent the freaking thing, and the rest is history. Moved home, continued radio, met this clown, and here we are today. But I was this close to... I was going to quit. I was done. And then I saw this article. I said, all right, I'll give it one more try, I guess. You want the Spuds Buckley, Jim?
Who doesn't?
Is that what you want?
Yeah, that doesn't have to be the whole thing, but... I got this little taste, and I have to get more of the flow.
Okay. We don't know who this guy is, this Spuds Buckley, but he did some interesting radio for a radio show called The Bear Man.
Sure.
Back in Buffalo, back in the 90s.
Yeah.
Early 90s, yes, early 90s. And with that, we'll play the first clip, and then we'll get to the newer clips that the faithful listeners have not heard yet.
The Fox Buffalo's home of quality, rock and roll. Hey, 636. Gracious, good morning. You're on your way with the Bear Man. We got the whole Fox crew. We're here at the reviewing stand for the first annual Fox Fools Parade. We're located just 1/2 mile.
Oh, this is appropriate because April Fools. This is what the Bear Man did—a fake parade in Buffalo.
Oh,
so this is kind of appropriate. April Fools is tomorrow. A lot of radio shows used to do this—the fake parade. All of a sudden, you tune in your favorite radio show, and all of a sudden, they're doing a parade, and you're like, oh, my God, I got to see this parade, and you're trying to figure out where it is.
You're like, where is it?
Right,
I got to get there.
Right, right.
Sounds exciting.
So he was doing that bit back in the day in Buffalo.
Fool's Parade. We're located just 1/2 mile west of Furman Boulevard near Shooters, and they're still working on...
Really selling it, by the way, with the hammering of the nails.
Yeah, what it was... There's a barn raising going on.
It should have been career coffins.
Yeah, I made it out of there alive, my friend.
Certainly did.
I made it out of there alive. The hammering of nails to just show everyone that they're still working on what? The floats?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Parade's going on.
We're located just 1/2 mile west of Furman Boulevard near Shooters, and they're still working on getting some of the barriers.
Some of these vendors we got over here, they want to know where the hell they're supposed to be.
Vendors. Where's let's look at the paper. Well,
la 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 la.
Good morning, Bear Man.
Ladies and gentlemen, put them together for Spuds Buckley.
I got the good intro, Jimmy. You got to admit that.
That's not the good intro.
Spuds Buckley.
I don't know what that is.
I got a ladies and gentlemen. Like, this is the moment you've been waiting
you
for.
You did get a good intro. The appropriate intro would have been a shotgun blast.
Hello, Bear Man.
Yeah, goodbye.
I kind of like
Spuds Buckley.
I kind of like looking at it as like, ladies and gentlemen, the Rolling Stones. I'm getting that type of intro.
Oh, really?
Give Jimmy? You one. Listen again. I'm getting a good intro. You got to respect that.
Good morning, Bear Man.
Ladies and gentlemen, put them together for Spuds Buckley.
I'm going to make a...
Hey!
I'm going to what?
Huh?
Oh
Spuds
yeah.
Talked.
All right. Well,
Spuds talk.
Good morning, Bear Man.
Ladies and gentlemen, put them together for Spuds Buckley.
I'm here to make a buck this morning.
Spuds, when aren't you here to make a buck, huh?
Hey.
So do you have your vendor permit? I'll trust you, okay?
Okay.
Now you're gonna be vending up and down the parade route today?
I'm gonna be selling fudgy wudgy bars this morning. And I got a slogan.
Hey, I got a laugh there, Jimmy.
Oh wait, here
I got a laugh.
Slogan.
Jimmy.
Huh?
Jimmy!
I hope.
I got to laugh.
No, I know.
I don't know why I got to laugh, to be honest with you.
Mm.
just was reciting something I used to hear on the beach out there on Long Island while I'm hanging out.
Bars.
And I got a laugh for it.
Down the parade route today?
I'm going to be selling fudgy wudgy bars this morning.
I know what the laugh was about.
What?
Somebody was sneaking up behind you with an open bear trap. All right, please, I'll hear the next line.
All right.
And I got a slogan.
Yeah?
A buck first.
Yeah. Okay, thanks very much, Spuds. Now, why don't you go vend somewhere else?
Why?
Huh?
Why?
All right.
It's cold.
Fudgy bars, fudgy.
Hey, Spuds, wait,
bars.
Before you go away, now, are those cold fudgy wudgy bars or are they warm ones?
Well, I heated them up in the microwave this morning.
There you go, buddy. All right.
Well,
why?
Well, it's just, it was cold out because it snows like in April and stuff. And that was kind of some of that exaggerated humor we enjoy.
Oh, yeah.
It's so exaggerated. Like, how could they still be fudge bars if you heat them up, if they're heated
and they melt?
Microwave.
But why does he start vending immediately? Like, when he says, I'm going to go vending, he starts, like, still in the mic vending. Like, listen to how fast.
I was out on the street, Jimmy.
But I mean, literally.
This was a live broadcast.
But he literally, Spuds.
Ignore the echo of the radio station. We were outside.
But
my
listen
friend.
To how fast he starts vending. He goes, all right. He immediately starts.
I had a job to do, Jimmy. I had a job to do.
Well, if it was to give the douche chill, you're hired.
All right. Continuing with Spuds Buckley.
Oh, my headphones fell off. Hold on.
Continue with Spuds Buckley. We don't have to do the backstory on this thing anymore, do we?
Rules.
Something I did way, 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 way back in the day.
Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Mert Snort. All right.
Hey, right, right. How you doing today? Good to see you. Good to see you. Now, where's the Spuds Buckley guy?
Oh, hold on. That's another character. Mert Snort. But first this, it jumped ahead on me, the CD player.
It's the first annual Fox Fools Parade. We're located 1/2 mile west of Furman Boulevard, right near Shooters. Plenty of free parking in the Shooters parking lot.
La, 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 la. Get
Spuds.
Your...
Spuds. Spuds Buckley, ladies and Spuds. How's it going with the sales of the Fudgy Wudgy bars?
Well, the buck first suck ain't working so well, so we're going to throw all this in the microwave, and we're going to start selling hot cocoa on a stick.
Got a big laugh, Jimmy.
It did.
What you try to do when you do this morning radio thing?
It did.
I don't know why you got a big laugh. But I got a big laugh.
I'd like to.
So bad.
I want to hunt the bear man down and just make him listen to this. He's having the time of his life, the bear man.
Oh yeah.
He's never laughed prior in 1980. He's watching. He's never laughed harder.
Well, thank you. I appreciate that.
Bear man is having the proverbial ball.
Right.
Ain't working so well, so we're gonna throw all this in the microwave and we're gonna start selling hot cocoa on a stick. Get your hot cocoa on a stick here. La, 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 la.
Well, we just about have the reviewing stand completely finished there, just putting the bunting up.
I was so close to having my own La 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 t-shirts. I was
you're trying to make
this
that the big catchphrase?
Close. And then stupid Garth Hemp had to take over mornings, and he didn't want anything to do with Spuds Buckley.
Oh, Garth Hemp, he heard a little Spuds, and he's like...
I told you, I had an audition. Like, I'm like, hey, I do this character, man. I did it for the Bear Man show. You might want to, you know, I don't know.
Might want to take a listen. I think you can like it.
So he made me do it like live. This. Just an L.A. douche comes to Buffalo in between gigs to do mornings for a little while. And I auditioned, and he was just like, yeah, thanks. But we won't be needing the services of Spuds Buckley. And I was that close to La 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 t-shirts. My friend.
I want to thank Garth Hemp, because that might have set you down the wrong path. What he did was he put up a stop sign, and it set you on the right path. Garth Hemp may, in a way, inadvertently be responsible for this radio program.
Yeah.
He probably started the path of Bitter Opie. Yes.
Garth Hemp.
I'm like, how does he not see... The brilliance talent. In this character. F him.
I owe my apartment to Garth Hemp. who would have guessed?
Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Mert Snort. All right.
I don't think I did Mert Snort. I'm not sure, though.
Oh.
If you did Mert Snort, I'm throwing myself through the window.
Mert, I'll follow through the hole you make in the window, Jimmy. I got
to
get out.
I don't think I had anything to do with Mert Snort.
Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Mert Snort. All right.
Hey, how you doing today? Good to see you. Good to see you. Now, where's this Fudge Buckley guy? I heard he has a, what, a buck for a buck or something I'm interested in. Buck for a buck. I haven't had that deal in years.
Earlier this morning, Spuds Buckley was out here as our exclusive vendor. What were they called, Spuds?
I was selling Fudgy Wudgy bars, and then, we heated them up.
How much were they?
A buck for a sock.
And they didn't sell too well.
No, so we threw it all in the microwave, and now we're selling hot cocoa on a stick.
Uh-huh.
But now that's starting to freeze back over, so we're back to Fudgy Wudgy bars. A buck for a sock. We got some soft ones and some that are getting a little harder.
Very harder. Oh, thank you. Thank you very much. You guys get out of here, okay? Thank you. Thank you very much.
Gotta be easy there with the double entendre, Spuds.
Yeah, Spuds, watch it.
What the hell are you talking about? You rascal.
I can only take one more clip today. I'm sweating horribly. I'll say this. I need something.
Hot cocoa on a stick is not a bad line. I mean, you know, honestly.
Yeah,
I'll make fun of the character, but that as a line, some of the lines are decent. The lines are better than I thought they would be.
Next up on the parade route would be the Chickawaga Liberation Army float. Oh, it's a delightful float, isn't it?
Very
nice float. Very nice. It's all done up in the shape it's in the shape of a Spud missile, and nobody better to describe it.
Oh boy, this clip is
labeled Spud missile.
Instead of Scud.
Yeah.
Well, Scud missiles were all the rage when we were doing it. This clip is labeled More Spud's Wackiness.
Wackiness.
Better to describe this float.
I like this float, but
Spud's Buckley. What's it look like for us there, Spud?
Well, it's all done up in pink flamingos and potato eyes. There's a huge tail fin on the back and the obligatory fuzzy dice up front.
Very nice.
Now, as it passes by around back, it has a winking flamingo and a sign which says, "This Spud's for you." Don't be alarmed. They're just shooting potato chips into the crowd. Hey, thank you, Jethro, Bingo, Bobo, and a special thank you to Tanya. Yeah.
There you go. All right, very nice. Let's hear it for the Chickawaga Liberation Army entry into this year's parade. Continuing on.
Okay, let me tell you something. You just heard my voice from, I don't know, about 15 years ago. I do not remember. I couldn't listen to these clips ahead of time.
No.
I do not remember saying what you just heard. Have no not even a recollection.
Really?
I have a recollection of doing this bit, but I don't have a recollection of describing that float.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. No.
I wish I could say the same thing.
Yuck.
Yuck.
That's all I can play today, man. I can't handle that.
Back
to pee real quick.
That's just as bad as I thought it would be.
Yeah.
Yeah, you never want to hear you're early on. Oh, Jimmy just went into the bathroom doing the la 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 la.
Well, we're thinking of coming up with the new Spuds Buckley.
Yeah, bringing him back. But of course, it can't be you.
No, because my voice is a lot deeper.
Yeah. So we.
I don't know if I can get my
recast.
Voice that high anymore. So we're attempting kind of like how they recast like Batman.
Yeah.
And Superman they mm-hmm. did, right? We want to recast Spuds Buckley, and we want the staff to attempt to be the brand new Spuds Buckley.
Now, I think they've heard tell of this.
Yeah.
And I wonder if any of them have been practicing.
Yeah. Dan, why are you walking toward the mic?
Oh,
no, I did come up with at least a general concept, I think.
For your Spuds Buckley?
Yeah, to at least base my Spuds character around. Now I just need to flesh out exactly how I would execute.
All right, we're going
to
have Spuds Buckley auditions. What we're going to do is we're going to set up a mic over there, kind of like, and the guys are going to audition. We're not even going to tell you who's who.
No.
Because it'll take away from it, especially for the people that really know the characters of this radio show. Maybe some listener submissions, you thinking it?
Yeah, I think listeners have heard enough Spuds Buckley where they could probably do a pretty fair impression.
And we recast the brand new Spuds Buckley, and maybe we even, like, as a goof, throw them out on the streets of New York to do Spuds Buckley-type things.
Oh, God.
And then maybe I could finally get my La 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 t-shirt. That's all I want in life, is a La 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 t-shirt.
And the winner gets to kneel in front of Patrice and eat a Fudgy Wudgy bar.
uh, I think I have another tape at home. I know I used to sing. I know I used to sing songs too.
Wait, what songs would you sing?
I don't really remember. I swear, Jimmy, this stuff I don't remember. I remember I did a
parodies or
I remember real songs? I did a song for the Bills when they were in the Super Bowl, and it was kind of like it's Super Bowl Sunday, but just picture high voice. But that was the hook.
Okay, now just picture the goosebumps that just came up on my arm. Oh wow!
And I think I did. And I think I
really did.
I think I reworked Truck In by the Grateful Dead as well, if I remember. But that's all I
need to suck in. Oh, that makes me laugh. Yeah. All right. Well, we all got those ones from our. He can't listen. Anna can't listen to his first time on your show.
Yeah, I know.
I'm
that's funny.
I'm sort of all right with it. It's really, really douchey, but. I'm all right with it. I think it could be funny though if we try to cast the news. Jimmy, what up?
Hey, goosebumps.
Oh, I really did. He came up on my arms. That's terrible.
What's bad about it?
I don't know. You're giving me goosebumps.
Well, how did the Super Bowl song go? Like the first line. How was that?
I can't do that. Remember? It's Super Bowl Sunday.
It's Super Bowl Sunday.
Oh, I got to find this tape. I don't know if it's labeled anymore.
Oh.
I'll try to dig it up tonight. What the hell? I got to go through a lot of boxes still, but I'll try to find the Spuds Buckley songs. And then, let's cast the brand new Spuds Buckley. That could be really funny. Listener submissions, if you want to send in a clip of you doing Spuds, we'll play it on the air. What the hell? All right? All right, and that's where we are with the Spuds Buckley thing. Once again, don't forget about the Animation Festival, Thursday, June 5th at Roseland Ballroom. Animations from the listeners, cash prizes, a couple comedians. It's going to be very, very exciting. We're giving away a lot of money for this. Red carpet, celebrity guest judges. This is what you need to know today. Tickets will go on sale this Friday, at 8 a.m., through Ticketmaster. The tickets are going to cost $10, and there will be a service charge. We have nothing to do with that because we're trying to keep this a cheap ticket for everybody, okay?
Yeah.
What? And all the info is up on oandaradio.com. What?
I'm only laughing because I was sitting here when that was played, and when you said that, and his arms, Ant's arms are folded. People can't see. And it was just like he just went, oh, and looked out at his arm. It was
pumped. I really did.
Steven S. from Bayshore, holy crap, Ope, you just made every male listener turtle. Oh, man. And I remember being pissed when this Garth Hemp guy said, I don't really want to do this Spud Buckley thing on my show.
Can we just call him smartest man in the world, yeah. Garth Hemp? He needs a title.
You have a guy we owe our careers to.
Yes, the genius.
Hey, look at Phil in Atlanta. Phil, what's up?
Opie, yeah. don't try to turn Spud Buckley into a funny bit. Just let him die back in 1993. You know, I think Opie's trying to bring him back, like, this is kind of... He's trying to make it into therapy for him, like going on Maury and facing your fears. That's why he's great.
It is so much deeper than that. Phil writes, stop trying to turn Spuds into a funny thing. It's so much deeper than that. My girl brings it up all the time. She goes, why do you like feeling really uncomfortable? Like, she's trying to figure out where that comes from. I am sitting here so uncomfortable right now. You think I'm sitting here like, oh, this is great? I feel so uncomfortable. My body temperature is way up there. I'm sweating on my, I don't know. I'm sweating profusely. I need like a paper towel or something. I like feeling uncomfortable. I like getting cringy. I like putting people in weird spots where it makes people in the studio with me kind of like walk out of the studio.
Yeah.
Or walk behind equipment.
Yeah,
I've always been like this. I don't know what it is, but I like feeling incredibly uncomfortable.
But I got to disagree with the listeners. Like, stop trying to make Spuds funny. Well, that's...
It's already funny.
It is
funny. But it's not... The material itself's not funny, but the fact that you're... It's funny in a different way.
Of course. It is very entertaining, though, to hit your friend under the... Really under a bus.
Yeah.
Like, you're under the bus in a way like you're stretched out, so the wheels run over your ankles and your arms. But that's funny.
Yeah. Dan, can I hear just a little taste of your Spuds?
How about it, Dan? Boss wants something.
You could even turn around so we don't have to look at you. Go over there.
I haven't been working on it.
How can you work on it? How much work does it require?
Yeah.
How much work, really?
La, 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 la.
Wow.
That's
you just got to sound like a douche, and you did very well.
Thank you very much.
You didn't say anything, though.
Oh, yeah, that's why I need to actually write the script.
Well,
yeah.
How about we come back? Not a script, but how about if Dan has a couple lines? We come, Dan's a comic, thinks on his feet.
All right.
We'll do that when we come back. You do a la la la, a line or two.
You got it, Jim.
It could be the beginning of casting the new Spuds Buckley.
Wow.
I have a feeling Sam's going to win this. No offense.
Really?
To your radio partner there, but I think Sam's going to win this because I think he could get his voice high. You got to be able to get your voice high.
Is that part of it? There's no, like, I don't know, kind of a reinterpretation of Spuds, maybe.
I'm not going for reinterpretation.
You want the exact.
I want to
feel
like.
Can we cast it black, like the Honeymooners and stuff? Maybe the new Spuds Buckley's a black guy?
No. I want to feel like I'm looking at Spuds Buckley from 1993.
Punch him in the face?
Yes, exactly. Then I don't need to get that dumb time machine. Wonderful.
Wonderful.
Opie and Anthony.
That was damn good.
Hey, I know Drew is always looking for something to work off for another remix. Here's one for you.
F you, Drew Boogie.
Work with that one, okay?
Thank you. F you, Drew Boogie.